This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Free Talk Live. This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us on the radio waves here. We'll give you the toll-free numbers and our Skype here in a moment. With you tonight, you've got Ian
Ridley
and Mark.
Dave Ridley is back. Hey, Dave, welcome back to the show.
That is my name, right?
RidleyReport.com.
Oh, that's right. Dave, okay, Ridley. Because my website, yeah, okay.
Is here. Back again. You were gone for a couple months. You're going to make a regular pilgrimage to Colorado to see some family and report on the Colorado bureaucrats and get into their hair a little bit.
Actually, not really. I did focus on some federal bureaucrats while I was there, since they're of interest to New Hampshire residents. And I focused some. There was a Confederate flag burn near me while I was there, and that's of interest to everybody. But I try not to. I am not interested in what Colorado City Council is doing or Colorado Springs City Council is doing. So I do try to avoid. So, you know, keep it interesting to New Hampshireites because, you know, like I always say, I've got Alizé Stepinitz syndrome. If it's not in New Hampshire, it's not quite real. So,
you are Dave Ridley from the Ridley Report. Our longtime listeners certainly know who you are. But if people are just tuning in tonight, they should go to RidleyReport.com. We'll talk more about that here in a little bit. Dave, you wanted to talk tonight about something that I've had in my show prep for a few days, but we just haven't gotten to it yet. The story is kind of all over the place, but I have the version from the Concord Monitor. And this is getting headlines all across the United States, and that is there's a library in Lebanon, which is not to be confused with Lebanon, Lebanon, New Hampshire.
Yeah, that's right. Here in New Hampshire and, you know, the Northeast and probably around the country, they have a tendency to sort of rename things. First off,
repronounce rather.
Repronounce.
Spelling is the same.
Yeah, you got no business naming your city after some other place. I mean, it's a unique place. It deserves a unique name. Mm. I mean, for God's sakes, the first mayor didn't have a wife. Name it Charlottesville, or you know, well, I guess they took that one. Name it. Yeah, Charlottes Town. I mean, there's lots of things you can do here. Charlottesburg. There's all of these things, and you don't need to go naming it after some other place.
Well, they did. And
first, they name it after Lebanon, and then they mispronounce it.
So what happened is, according to David Brooks over the Concord Monitor, a public library in Lebanon has found itself at the center of a complicated debate over internet privacy and safety. After questions from the Department of Homeland Security led the library to think twice about participating in the global anonymous web surfing network known as Tor. So what is Tor? I mean, beyond the summary that they've given here.
Well, it stands for the Onion Router.
That's right.
It's a anonymizing service.
Allegedly.
Open source anonymizing service created in part by the government.
Yes, which is why some people really worry about Tor.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's a lot of Edward Snowden supported it, and he probably knows a lot more about security than I do.
And it is an open source project, right? So anybody that has the programming chops can go and edit the source, and they can read through it and see if there's any kind of questionable code in there that might allow the government to kind of control things, if you will. I think that Tor seems pretty safe, given the amount of the vast amount of illegal things that are going on Tor and the relatively small number of arrests that come from the world of Tor. Of course, the most infamous has to be Ross Ulbricht, the man who was accused and ultimately convicted and sentenced to life in prison for running a website on Tor called the Silk Road, which allowed people to buy and sell drugs, fake IDs, hacking tools, among other things that might not necessarily be legal in whatever political jurisdiction that you find yourself. And one of the big questions on the Silk Road case was, how did they find the server in the first place? Because the FBI did get their hands on the Silk Road's server, and that was what allowed them to download all the information from the server and, you know,
it's still a secret.
Go through it. Yeah, they never got to that in the trial. They never explained that detail.
We sure are getting off topic.
Yeah, no, I understand that. Well, it's important to talk about what Tor is if we're going to explain why it matters that the library is going to shut down or has shut down its Tor server. So the way Tor kind of works, and this is a very layman's explanation, the reason it's called the Onion Router is because there are layers in Tor. Instead of you know, being able to trace one computer to another, how they're connecting over the regular internet, Tor bounces traffic between multiple sort of anonymizing servers. And how exactly that works, I don't know. But, you know, it's supposedly like undoing the layers of an onion. And so in Tor, or, you know, on this Tor traffic, when you run one of these Tor nodes, like the library was doing, you don't ultimately know what it is that's being passed through your node. You don't have any control over that. So someone could be sending information about, you know, buying and selling drugs or illegal pornography or bomb making, you know, kits and things like that. Who knows what, you know, is going on Tor? And I suspect that's one of the reasons why the federal government decided to put some pressure on this particular library and some of the things that they told them. The director of the Lebanon Public Libraries, Sean Fleming, said, "I was surprised at the reaction. They turned off their Tor server last month until the library's board of trustees can decide what to do with the project. The server was the first in the country to be operated by a public library under the Boston-based Library Freedom Project, which advocates for open software and privacy projects for public libraries. Fleming shut off the server after it had run for about a month, with Lebanon police raised the issue with city officials. Fleming said, I can understand the law enforcement perspective. It's a really difficult question. How can you tell if the bad is outweighing the good?
You can't, and you have to let the chips fall where the chips fall.
Well, that's just it. You don't have any idea what's going on. And the, you know, Tor gets a lot of bad press because of the, you know, child porn and the drugs sales and the, you know, various illegal things that go on there. But it's also really useful for anonymizing other things. Like, let's say somebody wants to leak out some information to WikiLeaks, for instance, or, you know, some other kind of thing that, you know, you want to remain anonymous but get something out there to the internet where there's no trace of who it was that actually uploaded this, let's say, damning information about Hillary Clinton or, you know, Barack Obama or George Bush doing something naughty. You know, you don't want that kind of stuff attached to your name necessarily because they're going to come after you. So if you're using Tor as sort of, you know, this refugee protection, if you will, then that could be really helpful to people.
Well, the other thing, the reason I mentioned this as show prep is that we have something we can add to the mainstream press coverage. And that is that either a Free Stater or an ally of the Free Staters is leading a protest tomorrow or a demonstration of support for the trustees and their decision to at least briefly run Tor.
Is the trustee meeting happening tomorrow?
I got the impression from the Facebook post that it was. That it says trustees meeting is at 7. We should be there at 6 so more people can see our signs. Also make signs. Unquote. But it's a, quote, rally to support the staff and trustees of the Kilton Public Library for supporting free speech online, unquote, unquote.
I think that's excellent. And this is an issue that is right up the alley of the liberty activists here in New Hampshire, the people who've moved here as part of the Free State Project. And we're three of those people. We're early movers. The people who've moved here are generally very technically savvy. They're people who tend to be in the IT field, many of them, because it's easy, relatively easy to pick up and move if you're an IT person. You can kind of work from home, or, you know, your career's flexible enough where your services are in demand. And so a lot of the earliest movers and early movers for the Free State Project work in the IT field. They know a thing or two about Tor. They know why it's valuable. And I think they're the right people to get on this. And I'm really excited that they're doing this. Now, when you say it's a protest, sign waving is one thing, but are they going to go testify at this meeting? Is it a public hearing? Can people go and speak to the trustees at said meeting, or do they have to like send letters or something?
I'll check the page and get back to you on that during the show, hopefully.
Yeah. So the spokesperson here at the library, the director, Sean Fleming, says that it's difficult because the whole nature of the project is anonymous. What's going through that server? I don't know. Tor was not actually accessible at the Kilton Library the way the regular internet is available because the library had not downloaded a Tor browser onto the public terminals. Rather, the library was using a portion of its infrastructure to handle traffic for Tor, which is a peer-to-peer system whose internet traffic has passed or is passed from participant to participant instead of through central systems, making it harder to intercept. We'll tell you more about it, and you can share your thoughts on Tor and privacy and whether you think this library should shut down its Tor server at 855-450-FREE.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Ricky LeBlanc, admitted in Mass only. Sokolov Law, LLC, Chestnut Hill, Mass. Ken Levin, responsible attorney in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Greg Hobby, New Jersey. The choice of lawyer is an important decision that should not be based solely upon advertisements. While this firm maintains joint responsibility, most cases of this type are referred to other attorneys for principal responsibility. If you know what mesothelioma is, you or someone you love has likely been impacted by this devastating cancer. You may be entitled to compensation. Call Sokolov Law today. 1-800-218-HELP. The only known cause of mesothelioma is asbestos exposure. Thousands of hardworking men and women, including many U.S. veterans and industrial workers, have been diagnosed with mesothelioma because manufacturers knew the dangers but put profits ahead of people. An estimated $30 billion in court-ordered trusts has been set aside to pay money to asbestos victims. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma, call now. You may be entitled to receive compensation without ever going to court or filing a lawsuit. Call for a free legal consultation at 1-800-218-HELP. That's 1-800-218-HELP.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio waves, and you can bring up anything that you'd like. We're talking about Tor, and a library actually happens to be here in New Hampshire, the first library to ever start running a Tor node, has now shut it down after being contacted by the Department of Homeland Security. They're going to allow their board of trustees to make the decision as to whether or not this should come back online. Tor stands for the Onion Router. It's an anonymizing system for the internet. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us, 855-450-FREE. With you in the studio tonight, Ian here.
Ridley.
And Mark.
855-450-3733. We also have Skype. You can Skype into the show. Username here is lrn.fm. Now, ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting cryptocurrencies. Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. And they're a licensed money services business. You can get cryptocurrencies with money order or check. If you don't know what Bitcoin is yet, go take some time and check out Bitcoin.com. When you're ready to get started and get some Bitcoin, you can go to ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, you can even do it from your smartphone with their app, which you can get from ExpressCoin.com. Now, we're going to want to remember our code. It's coupon code FTL, FTL like Free Talk Live. And that'll save you on up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency. You will pay no transfer fee when you use ExpressCoin.com and code FTL.
ExpressCoin.com.
Let's go to Glenn. He's in Philly. And then we'll talk more about the Tor situation and privacy on the internet. Glenn, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Dave, and Mark.
Oh, okay. Actually, just some preliminary issues. First of all, the chips always fall between the couch cushions. It's a law of physics. You know, somebody said something about letting the chips fall where they may. You know, they always fall between the couch cushions.
Gotcha.
Yeah, you got to watch out for that. Go ahead.
Change
what else you got, Glenn?
Yeah, yeah. Also, I'm somewhat puzzled. I'm uncertain about these nomenclature strictures you're imposing on geographic locations. So, like, what about New York, New Jersey, New London, New Amsterdam? Is it okay to use a something that's named after someplace else if you stick a new in front of it?
I think so.
What about, like, you?
Yeah, I'm willing to let that one go. Sure. You know, you can't just name your – I think it's fair to call it Manhattan Beach, but it really bothers me that it's on the other side of the country right next to Venice Beach.
Oh, yeah. Well, what about Springfield, right?
I mean, yeah, there's a lot of Springfields, and I've got to say yeah. I'm
take
willing
me to
get
the state that Springfield is in.
I'm willing to go ahead and grant Springfield to Illinois because they have made it – is it their capital, right?
Well, wait a minute, but Springfield, Vermont won the Simpsons contest.
I don't care. But the Simpsons is more important than the state capital?
The Simpsons is very important.
Yes, the Simpsons is more important than state capitals.
Who's making the decisions here?
I am.
This isn't a democracy. You guys are my you're my viceroys. I am the king of everything.
No, you're not.
All right.
So I'm deciding it's Springfield, Illinois.
If they're old enough, what about Memphis? Cairo,
that is a really good one. That's the best one I've ever been asked on this question. Memphis. Yeah, I know you don't. That's because you went to the smart school, buddy. Memphis is a very famous place in Egypt a long time ago, but it's gone. I know. That's what's really great about all this. I'm going to say that.
Can you be more condescending?
No,
I can't.
if the city's been gone for 2,000 years, okay, it's good. You can rename it.
All right.
I'm willing to go 1,000 years.
Wow. All right. Very good. I'm not too informed. I don't know too much about your talk, but I personally like Tor. The hammer thing's really cool.
The hammer thing?
The hammer of Thor, yeah. I think he means.
Oh, Thor. Got
Thor.
It.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks, Glenn, for the call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
Where's Timbuktu?
I have no clue.
Constantinople.
It's in Constantinople? That no longer exists, right? Didn't they change it to Turkey?
Yeah, they changed it to Turkey. That's exactly right. Siam.
Well, Thailand.
No, well, you're not supposed to answer for him. Oh. He's the one who went to the smart school.
There's another Simpsons line, you know, where Mr. Smithers goes in and he goes, Put this parcel on the next autogyro to Siam.
Yes.
Because he's so old, he can't remember that the modern names of things are.
It was a telegram or something like that. Yeah.
Yes, right.
So back to Tor, the anonymizing system for the internet, where the Kilton Public Library apparently was the first ever public library to operate a Tor node under the Boston-based Library Freedom Project, which advocates for open software and privacy projects for public libraries. And they ran it for about a month before shutting down their Tor node after a phone call, apparently from the Department of Homeland Security, which scared the library operators into shutting it down.
Oh, man, you don't answer the phone when the Homeland Security... It's like you don't open the door when the police come, and if the Homeland right. Security's on the other end, you hang up and ask them if you can talk to them in person where you can record, you know?
I would prefer not to talk to them at all, but yes, certainly better to record a conversation and certainly better to generally not talk to them, period, because it certainly, in most cases, won't benefit you to talk to the police. Unless you've specifically reached out to them and they're calling you back for something. So I would very much dissuade people.
Well, I guess the thing, yeah, with a phone, it's probably best to ask, you know, would you have any objections if I record this? And if they say no, then you hang up.
Yeah,
I can't talk to you anymore then.
Yeah. I'd still want to have an attorney or something like that present to me. These guys are serious business. And
yeah,
you know, if they determine
they're deaf.
If they determine that you've told them a lie, you'll go to prison.
They're the end of your life.
Tor was actually not accessible at the Kilton Public Library. This is a New Hampshire library, but they did have the sort of the back end of Tor running, which was just sort of moving traffic around the internet and helping to anonymize people online. Allison Macrina, former Massachusetts librarian who heads the Library Freedom Project, says libraries are well positioned to run one of these Tor nodes. She says they already have public internet services and can afford some of the bandwidth. An individual hosting this could have some issues. So library connections tend to be fairly beefy. You know, the library probably has one of the better internet connections in your town. And so, allocating 10% of their connection to a Tor node is something they can do without really a big deal. That's what she's saying.
So what kind of connection do you have to have in order for it to be?
Honestly, I don't know. I mean, the larger, the better in that case. So I couldn't tell you if there's a certain minimum that you can operate Tor. I think you could probably run Tor even with a relatively slow connection, but obviously that's going to slow down the traffic that's going through your particular node. Because again, Tor is routing traffic through multiple nodes on its network, and the slowest node is going to slow down all that traffic.
My experience with Tor, when I went on to, and spend some time, I went on to take a look at the first Silk Road just mm-hmm. to see, what is this thing like?
Because it's not illegal to log on to the underground marketplaces.
No, I didn't buy anything there. I just wanted to take a look. And it was slower than Christmas. I literally mm-hmm. would just go back on a regular browser and look at stuff while the next page loaded. It was slow. It's slower than my son getting ready to get in the car. I mean, it's slow.
It's gotten a lot better, but it's still certainly slower than your regular internet.
I did want to mention there's some options here for the ways people can help with the situation. Dennis Goddard, one of the New Hampshire Liberty activists, posted a message on Facebook that said, quote, Sean Fleming, the director of Lebanon Public Libraries, said the best way to express support would be to use the library contact form, and he would be reading those submissions into the meeting minutes, unquote.
Did he happen to include a link to that contact
form?
Oh,
yeah, it's leblibrary.com.
Why don't you send that to me? I'll put it on our Facebook page, and that way listeners can just go straight there at facebook.freetalklive.com or twitter.freetalklive.com. It'll show up there as well. 855-450-FREE. Trying to protect some privacy here. It's Free Talk Live.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Are you still looking for that one iodine that you can really trust? a medical doctor-endorsed product that is backed by honest research and true integrative science, then search no further. Go to NutraMedical.com for Dr. Bill Deagle's Nutriodine, proven time and time again to be the very best iodine available for you. Nutriodine is the only Tesla-activated monatomic plasma iodine in the world. It optimizes mitochondrial function and generation of new mitochondria, from totally neutralizing the venom from a desert recluse spider bite in Southern California to eliminating malaria parasites reported by medical missionaries in Central India. Dr. Bill's Nutriodine is simply the most powerful healing formula there is. Nutriodine clears the body of all known pathogens, restores it to an alkaline state, and even promotes stem cell regeneration. Order Dr. Bill's Nutriodine today at 888-212-8871 or visit us online at NutraMedical.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Is negative content or comments on the web affecting your personal or professional reputation? Unfavorable comments, embarrassing pictures, videos, legal documents, and bad tweets can ruin your personal life, your career, or your business. It happens a lot, and it's just not fair. But what can you do? Reputation.com can protect your good name. Get a free consultation now at 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771. Call right now for a free expert reputation analysis. It's easy to squash the unfair attacks with our patented system, and the analysis is absolutely free. Make the best things about you jump out in searches. Protect your personal and professional reputation, your business, and your income. Get your free reputation analysis from Reputation.com right now. Call 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live, and you're invited to join us here toll-free. 855-450-FREE is our number, 855-450-3733. We've got other Tor-related news here tonight. You've got the story we started with about the library that shut down its Tor node. The first library to ever start a Tor node has now turned it off after being contacted by the Department of Homeland Security. There's a lot of stories on the internet about this, and activists here in New Hampshire are going to be going to the Board of Trustees meeting tomorrow night, and I did put a link up to the library's communications link on our Facebook and Twitter, so those of you who support privacy and support the Tor system can contact the library's Board of Trustees, and you probably want to do that tonight or early tomorrow so they can have that information for their meeting tomorrow evening. And support the idea of, hey, you know, this is a good idea of giving people the right to privacy. And, you know, in this day and age when the government is more invasive than it's ever been into our digital worlds, to actually have a government library working against that invasion of our privacy could be a good thing to have. So,
well, it's interesting how the librarians have stood up against what the Patriot Act and now for people's privacy. I mean, you know, there's some apparently some pretty pretty raw customers there running the old library.
A surprise, eh?
Yeah. I can tell you one of the greatest anti-war activists that I know is a former librarian.
Wasn't there some famous movie about the Middle East where like the librarian takes over a country or something like that because he's such a military genius?
No, I don't know.
It's really good. I can't remember the name of it. It's recent.
Now, one thing you don't need Tor for to do on the internet is to get huge discounts from Amazon. You can go to saveatpurse.com, wherever you are, and learn about how this happens. It's a very simple process. It involves your Amazon wish list being imported to saveatpurse.com and then somebody else basically buying your stuff for you, so you send them Bitcoin. That's the trick, is you have to have Bitcoin to save 20% or more over or less. It's up to you. You can actually choose the percentage discount you want. The average is 20% over at saveatpurse.com. So if you have Bitcoin, you can save big on pretty much anything you need to buy to live your life through Amazon. I just recently got my record purchase 40% off of a Blu-ray from saveatpurse.com. One of our listeners says he got 50% off from, what was it? He got like a $10, something relatively small.
Yeah, it was between $10 and $11.
But yeah, he got 50% off. Now, I don't know how likely it is you'll get 50% off when, again, the average is 20, but you can try it. If you're patient, then you're more likely to get larger discounts. So it works really, really well. I've done it a couple dozen times over at saveatpurse.com. And if you don't have Bitcoin, you can still go there and learn about how it works. And this is, in my opinion, one of the best reasons to get Bitcoin. Saveatpurse.com. Law enforcement agencies object to Tor and other systems that make it difficult to trace communication online. This is from the Concord Monitor, noting that they have been implicated in such things as child pornography rings because they allow relatively secure trading of pictures and files. Advocates praise Tor for its ability to provide safety to people who need protection.
You must respect my authority.
Yeah, such as abused spouses or dissidents in repressive countries, as well as providing privacy to individuals. Questions about the Kilton Public Library's participation in Tor were first raised by the Department of Homeland Security, after which they made their way to Lebanon police. And a lieutenant in the police department, Matthew Isham, said police weren't necessarily against the idea of the town library hosting a Tor node. He said, "Our purpose is not to shut this down. Our purpose is to inform, to ensure that all the departments in the city should know about it." The Lebanon Public Library's Board of Trustees, which unanimously supported the project back in June, is scheduled to discuss the issue at its meeting tomorrow night. And the story goes on here.
Do you think they'll break weak, or do you think they'll stick with it?
I don't know.
When you support something that is not opposed by bad guys, why would you stop supporting it because it's opposed by bad guys?
Well, because they may not see the police as bad guys. That's what you're saying the bad guys are.
Yes.
Is that right? I don't think it's fair to necessarily say that all police are bad guys. I don't know if that's what
you're
saying.
They are in one way or another, yes.
Yeah, I guess you can make that argument. I think a lot of them are people who believe they're doing good, though, right? I don't think that
some are a lot worse than others.
Yeah, I don't think that they believe that they are bad guys. And
well, the Tor is easy to paint as a bad place because of the, for me, it's not the, the online drug markets. Obviously, to me, what that means is that those are making the use of drugs, frankly, safer by people who wish to make the choices to use that. But, the child predators and the people sharing child pornography, the folks that have the credit cards they're selling, credit card information they're selling, and those sorts of things that use it, they make it very easy to vilify Tor. I think everybody should have privacy. But the problem is that some people, what some people use privacy for?
Well, and the authorities make it very easy for you and me to be taken down by disarming us, preventing us from using various services, preventing us from doing all kinds of things that we could do to protect ourselves and stop being afraid.
By the way, the ACLU is going to be weighing in on this. One of their representatives will be there speaking. And they're supporting the use of the Tor node. I think this is going to be an interesting meeting. I wish I could be there for it, but I'll be on the air at the time. Are you planning on going to cover?
I'm driving all the way up to Lebanon for a meeting.
You're not
but
going
there,
up
like
either?
I said, it's not about anything else. It's about efficiency. What can you do from where you are to support what they're doing? I did invite 150, well, maybe more like 120 New Hampshireites to the event. And they, when I did that, they had only, the Facebook organizers had only, they'd only invited about 200. So I invited a third more than they had already invited. Well, there's always something you can do from where you are.
Yeah, that's true. And one of the nice things about the Free State Project, the reason the three of us are here together in the studio tonight, because we've all moved here as part of the Free State Project, which is a movement of 20, what will hopefully be 20,000 people who will move to New Hampshire and get active for liberty. We've already had over 1,500 people as early movers as we are here. And so one of the nice things is those 1,500 people are spread throughout New Hampshire, most within the southern tier. And Lebanon is within that southern portion of the state. It's sort of more central, I guess, but still to the south of the middle
notches,
of the state,
as it's known as.
Yeah. And so there's a fair amount of people already there in the Lebanon area. In fact, the president of the Free State Project up until recently was living in Lebanon. So there are a number of people.
Didn't the founder live in Lebanon?
The founder, I believe, does live in Lebanon, Okay. Actually. Yeah. So the Jason Zorins could go and speak at this. And there's a number of people that are up there. And so each area, each region of New Hampshire has its own sort of group of activists. And so we don't have to go up to Lebanon because there are people there who are going to be there likely because they, you know, could walk to this particular meeting. And the more movers we get here as part of the Free State Project, the less moving about the state all of us will have to do to attend these things when things like this come up.
Have we made clear that it's not at the Hilton Library, that it's apparently at the main Lebanon Library?
I went ahead and posted the link to... I guess the online form, so anybody can weigh in on this.
I think that's where it is. I'm not sure.
I imagine they're going to take opinions more seriously from people that actually live in the town. Mm-hmm. So I would hope that people will physically show up there in real life and come out for privacy in this case. And the story here does say that even if this particular library doesn't turn its server back on, that others will take its place. And I hope that that's true. I suspect it will be more true if they do turn their node back on. If the news comes out that the Kilton Library has decided and voted again unanimously to reactivate this Tor server, that could energize other libraries who are kind of watching and waiting in the wings, like, okay, what are they going to do? And, you know, once one person is willing to step out there, so to speak, or in this case, one organization is willing to put itself out there, others may be willing to follow its lead.
What other sorts of places might put up Tor nodes?
Well, anyone can do it. If you have an internet connection, you can run a Tor node.
Right, but you said that you had to have basically a beefy internet connection.
Well, that's certainly better for Tor if you do have a better internet connection.
Right, because it's going to be the slowest as its slowest link.
Correct.
And so you're better off. Frankly, you're not really helping. If they have enough links, then you're not helping by adding another one that's slow.
I guess you could make that argument. Of course, the other argument is that the more nodes, the better in general. Not all traffic is going to be routed through your machine.
The more
machine.
Nodes, the slower.
Well, not necessarily. It just depends on which nodes your traffic is
all
passing through.
The helpful people.
Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates? Or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education? Or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
The human body is more than 60% water. Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to alkavision.com to find out more. That's alkavision.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms.
I get it.
You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realists, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! The federal government does not like privacy at all. They are very upset about a number of issues on the technical world that increase your privacy and therefore occludes them from knowing what it is that you're up to. They don't like that.
Governments like information. They've always liked information. For those of you who are big Bible readers, I mean, Jesus was born supposedly during the time of a census. Well, you know, they just want to count people. Mm. They just want to know their names. They want to know where they live. They want to know what they're doing. They want to know what color they are. They want to know how many kids and dogs and cats and doors and bedrooms and everything you've got. They feel like they need to know this information. The reason they need to know this information is they are not a service organization. They are livestock farmers, and you are their tax livestock.
I wouldn't even give them the main question on the census. You know, the one question about how many people live in the house? I wouldn't even answer that question.
I wouldn't even answer whether I've filled out the census or not.
I welcomed the census lady into my house, and every question she asked me, I asked her first and then wrote down the answer on a piece of paper.
And then you answered it for her.
And then I asked her, and when she gave me the answer to the question,
you then answered
for
her
house, and then I answered it for mine. I just wanted her to understand what an invasive set of questions this is.
Yeah. Did you get video of that?
I didn't consider doing that. Would have been a good idea. I'm not much of the videoer. You know, like,
well,
it's just not my
thing.
You
don't get to pick what's happening in front of you. When it's happening and it's interesting, video is the answer, whether you're a video person or not.
And I did get video. The two times the census came to my front door, did not participate with them. And I explained to them why. It ended up being kind of interesting footage. I thought it was an interesting conversation with them as well. Now, the census certainly by no means is the most invasive of all government bureaucracies. The Department of Homeland Security is the one that is angry about this library that's running the Tor node, or was running the Tor node. Now the library has shut it down, and there's a board meeting tomorrow night as to whether or not they will turn it back on. And that aside, the FBI and the Department of Homeland Security at large are also very upset at things like Google and Apple putting in total phone encryption onto their more recent operating systems for their phones' operating system. So you actually have like a level of encryption for the entire device that is now something you can supposedly access from just the default settings in the phone. And the Department of Homeland Security was crying from the rooftops about this, about how this was, you know, going to empower criminals, and that the bureaucrats need to have a back door into all of these systems. Which, of course, defeats the purpose of privacy.
What is it that Facebook meme says? The reason our criminals are our heroes is because our leaders are thugs.
Yeah, and this is another thing. I was just thinking about it yesterday or the day before, and it seems like the heroes are getting darker and more criminal in movies and television shows. I mean, from the 80s. You had a lot of cops as the good guys.
I see what you're saying.
And now, they were necessarily...
Miami Vice.
Yeah, they weren't always... They didn't always follow the rules.
Uh-huh.
But they were the cops.
Dirty Harry.
And it's getting less and less like the cops are the good guys. And something's changing. I don't know what it is or why it is.
Well,
but
yeah,
those in charge had the power at one point, and it is slipping away from them.
When the Star Trek movies go anti-government, you know something is changing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have they?
In society. Yeah, if you look at the most recent Star Trek film, it's about the Federation going bad and having some crazy general trying to do terrible things to start a war.
Interesting. I haven't seen the newest one yet. They've got two of them, right? The remakes?
The two reboots. In this new timeline.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In other news that are related here, the FBI's director is claiming that Tor will not let criminals hide from his agents, which is a disturbing claim because there are a lot of people who are doing a lot of things that could get them arrested over the Tor system. FBI's director, this is from The Intercept, which is, by the way, the Glenn Greenwald site. So the FBI director, it's actually Dan Frumkin who's writing on this. FBI Director James Comey said on Thursday that criminals who think they can evade law enforcement using the dark web and the Tor network, which is designed to conceal internet addresses of the computers being used, are, quote, kidding themselves. Unquote. Comey was asked about criminal use of the so-called dark web, parts of the internet walled off from ready access, at a House Intelligence Committee hearing on cybersecurity Thursday. His answer referenced Tor, which was originally known as the Onion Router. Speaking in particular of people who view child pornography, Comey said, quote, they'll use the Onion Router to hide their communications. They think that if they go to the dark web, that they can hide from us. They're kidding themselves. Because of the effort that's been put in by all of us in the government over the last 5 years or so, that they are out of our view, unquote. Comey's statement could be read as an assertion that law enforcement in the U.S. has found a way to routinely thwart Tor's system for providing anonymity to users. If that's Comey's intended implication, and if it's true, it would represent an enormous expansion of the U.S. government's known abilities, as well as a significant blow to privacy advocates. But online security experts consulted by The Intercept cast doubt on that possibility, and Comey could simply have been referring to the kind of specifically targeted attacks that have been known to be successful in the past. For instance, a 2013 story based on documents leaked by Edward Snowden, the NSA whistleblower, described how the NSA had developed attacks against people using Tor by identifying Tor users and then attacking vulnerable software on their computers. But one top secret presentation titled Tor Stinks stated, quote, we will never be able to de-anonymize all Tor users all of the time, unquote. Now, that's a statement from the NSA.
Yeah.
So you've got the NSA saying, yeah, this isn't a perfect system. We can't really crack it. To the FBI saying, you can't hide, criminals. Now, which one of them is telling something closer to the truth?
I'm going to go ahead and believe that, yes, they can. If they put enough energy and time into deciding who you are, they can figure it out.
Yep.
However, when you use anonymizing stuff, you make it harder on them.
Oh, I wish it wasn't so much energy and time.
Agreed.
To use Tor.
It's not really that much energy to use Tor.
It's slower than Christmas,
no,
though.
No, it's really not that slow these days.
There are other
days.
Problems, too.
When's the last time you were on Tor?
I told you the last time I was on Tor.
A couple years ago, right?
Well, I don't know how long it's been, but whenever Silk Road number one
that was 2011.
Still up and running.
Silk Road came out in 2011, and that's probably the first time we talked about it. It was early or late 2011 or early 2012.
Tor's been around a lot longer than that.
I understand that, but you said the last time you used it was when the Silk Road.
Yeah.
And Silk Road was around in 2011.
Yes.
So, therefore, it's probably been 4 years or three years since you've used it.
That's the last time I used it.
So, here's how you do it. We'll talk more about the feds and their claims here in a moment, but just to break down, since, Dave, you think it's that difficult. It's really not. You just go and download the Tor browser. You open the Tor browser.
Then you look at a bunch of German.
German?
Yeah, every time I use it, it seems to have the wrong languages.
I've never experienced that at all. When was the last time you used
it? It thinks I'm in Brussels or something, you know.
Oh, okay, I see what you're saying. So when you're on Tor, your internet traffic is being routed in different places around the world. And so when you visit a regular website with Tor, because Tor allows you to browse the regular web anonymously, and it allows you to browse what's called the dark web, which sounds scary, but ultimately there's a lot of different content on the dark web.
Dark is light in this current inverted world we live in.
That's a good point. And so the dark web sites end in .onion. So any website that ends in .onion, you can't type that into your regular browser. You wouldn't want to either because it's usually like AQ2 and it's just a bunch of jumbled letters and numbers. So you can't use a regular browser for this. You download the Tor browser, which is so much easier than it was several years ago. Years ago, you had to download Tor and download a browser and go through a setup process with the browser to make sure that it'll work correctly with Tor. And then it was definitely a pain in the butt. It was also super, super slow back then. Now, it seems like there are a lot of Tor nodes that are being run that have significant bandwidth. I've seen downloads coming from Tor that are coming fairly quickly these days. So if you get good connections, you can actually browse fairly quickly with Tor. And downloading the browser is simple. It's already pre-configured for you. So you download this browser, you run the browser, and you have Tor.
That's
it
great,
is that
man,
simple.
I'm not in Brussels. I don't speak Flemish.
Well, that is one issue. That's these Tor exit nodes. So when you're browsing, I'm glad you brought me back to that. When you're browsing regular websites, they will think that you're somewhere you're not, which is sort of the point of it. And so when you go to Google, it might be like Google Finnish or whatever, or Google German, etc. And there are usually ways to, you know, sort of change the languages on those sites. So I can see that could be a frustration, right? But privacy is something that generally takes time and frustration. If you want to have privacy, you have to be willing to jump through a few extra hoops in order to have it. So if you're somebody who wants to leak some information about the government, if you're a woman who's or a man or whoever is being abused by a husband and, you know, or whatever, there's different reasons why people would use Tor if that doesn't include drugs and porn, then you're willing to jump through those extra hoops in order to have that extra level of privacy. So it's worth it. And now they've made it easier than it's ever been. Downloading that Tor browser, just go and Google it. You'll get right to the page you need to go to. Just search for Tor browser. And we'll talk more about the FBI's tough talk about Tor. Is it true that they've compromised the system? You can also...
It's like what Sun Tzu said.
Hold that thought. Oh, sorry. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows, pause and rewind live TV, even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. Police in Cleveland, Mississippi are looking for a suspected shooter, Shannon Lamb, in the slaying of history professor Ethan Schmidt at Delta State University. Shannon is said to be a staffer who received a doctorate in education this year. Cleveland Police Chief Charles Bingham was asked what the motive was in the fatal shooting.
Right now, we have no motive, and we're not going to speculate on a motive until we have facts in hand.
Lamb is also the suspect in the murder of a woman in Goshen, Mississippi, about 300 miles away. Kim Davis returned to work Monday for the first time since she was jailed for refusing to issue marriage licenses. Licenses are now being issued in Rowan County, Kentucky, without her signature or authorization. Harry Mehet, the attorney for Kim Davis, says the marriage licenses now being issued may be a sufficient religious accommodation.
If it's satisfactory to the plaintiffs and the court, then I think we will have found that win-win solution that we had been asking for all along.
Davis says that her religious beliefs say that marriage is only a union between one man and one woman. There is no relief from the wildfires that continue to plague California. Two major blazes in Northern California have caused 23,000 people to be evacuated. Red Cross spokeswoman Virginia Hart says many of the evacuees appear very shaken after fleeing the Valley Fire, but happy to find shelter at the Napa County Fairgrounds.
For the most part, people are really, really grateful for the generosity of the communities around them who have been donating goods and time and services and food, and have been really wonderful.
One person has died in the Napa County fire, an elderly disabled woman who was killed when her home was consumed by the wildfire. On Wall Street, the Dow by 62 points, the NASDAQ dropped 16, the S&P lower by 8, oil down 63 cents to close at $44 a barrel. More on these stories at townhall.com.
There are times when people need a little extra money, honest, hardworking people, and some banks don't always make it fast or easy. But finally, there's a company who gets it who could help my listeners that need it, Avant. You simply go to avantoffer.com on your computer or phone to check your rate risk-free with no effect on your FICO score. Complete your application in minutes and the funds could be in your account as soon as tomorrow. If any of my listeners need a loan between $1,000 and $35,000, go to avantoffer.com. Avant will give you a $50 Amazon.com gift card after you make your first payment on time. For this offer and to check your rate risk-free, go to avantoffer.com and enter promo code BORROW. That's AVANTOffer.com, promo code BORROW, avantoffer.com, promo code BORROW. Loans made by WebBank and by affiliates Avant Incorporated. California loans offered by Avant are made under finance lenders license number 603K124. Funds are generally deposited via ACH for delivery next business day. If approved by 4:30 p.m. Central Time, Monday through Friday. Amazon is not a sponsor of this promotion. Other restrictions apply. See website for details.
Leading up to this week's GOP debate, there's good news for the frontrunners.
Donald Trump and Ben Carson are widening their leads over the rest of the field in a just-released Washington Post ABC poll. Trump registers at 33% of Republican-leaning voters. Carson is at 20%. The rest of the field in single digits. And there's continuing concern for Democrat frontrunner Hillary Clinton. She's fallen below 50% for the first time, a drop of 21 points since July. Bernie Sanders and Vice President Joe Biden are virtually tied for second place at 24 and 21%, respectively.
Capitol Hill correspondent Wally Hines reporting. A government task force says a daily low-dose aspirin could help certain people in their 50s and 60s prevent a first heart attack or stroke, and they might get some protection against colon cancer at the same time. The guidelines are from the U.S. Preventive Services Task Force. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. If you owe the tax man more than $100 million, your check is no good at the IRS.
Beginning in 2016, the Internal Revenue Service says it'll reject all checks for more than $99,999,999. That's because check processing equipment at the country's Federal Reserve banks can't handle checks that large. The Treasury Department says checks of $100 million or more will have to be processed by hand. That'll increase the risk of theft, fraud, and errors.
Correspondent Jeremy House reports. The richest Americans will have to wire their tax payments electronically or write multiple checks for less than $100 million apiece. Leaders in the European Union can't come to terms on how many of the 120,000 refugees arriving in Italy, Greece, and Hungary will be split among member countries. In Hungary, police rolled a train car covered with coils of razor wire up to the border with Serbia. The makeshift obstacles being used to cap a strategic gap in the country's border fence. Townhall.com.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American-made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey System. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Free Talk Live.
And you can join us here on Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've been talking about Tor, which has been in the news over the last week or so after a library that had been running a Tor node has pulled it offline due to being contacted by the Department of Homeland Security, who is really upset over the idea of you having privacy on the internet.
Mammish.
With you tonight in the studio, you've got Ian.
I'm Ridley.
And Mark.
Ridley was in his sound effect mode there.
Mammish mode. Well, I was being the bureaucrat.
Is that what bureaucrats sound like to you?
No.
Oh, okay. Dave Ridley from RidleyReport.com is here with us. We're going to take your calls about whatever's on your mind, and you know, you're welcome to comment on privacy. Maybe you think people shouldn't have privacy. Maybe you agree with the federal government, the Department of Homeland Security, the NSA, and you think that this whole privacy thing is dangerous. People shouldn't have privacy. They could use it for things that are illegal, so no one should have it.
They shouldn't have free speech because they could use that for things that are unpopular.
Well, why would you want privacy anyway? Is it that you've got something to hide?
Yeah, you don't have to hide your social security number. Give it to everybody.
Well, obviously there's things that individuals need to keep secret, and you know, there's
well, the government certainly has plenty of them, secrets.
When you start thinking about the things that the government can get, emails, telephone calls, the sort of information, it may not matter for my life. Oh, they've found out that I'm going to be doing some weed eating this afternoon. How very interesting. Whereas when they start looking at judges, politicians, captains of industry, or whomever it is they're
looking
for.
Library directors.
When they find out that these people have secrets like mistresses and the funding deals they've taken for their campaigns and the varieties of skeletons that might be in the closets of these people, then they take people of power and they get them in their pocket. And this is how This is how bureaucracies are bolstered. You can just look through human history, and once the particular noble or prince or whatever gets the information, then they can never be ousted because they've got the information on everybody else. So this is a very bad thing, because what it does is it allows bad people to stay in power and never be checked.
Let's go to Libertarian Banker calling from He'd Rather Not Say. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Libertarian Banker.
Hey, guys. Listen, bankers and government officials have gotten way too cozy to the point where banks and other bankers are willing to tell on their fellow human beings for victimless crimes related to the war on drugs and other miscellaneous things. Mm-hmm. And what I'm talking about is the Bank Secrecy Act, which was first made in the 1970s and has been updated time and time again. You know, the last major revision was the Patriot Act. But it allows banks to basically monitor accounts. And
it does more than that. It forces them to. The cash transaction reports and the suspicious activity reports, to which I believe you're referring here, are mandated on these banks.
But it's not just those. Those are the most commonly known. But there are also monitoring of other financial, let's say a check casher or some other finance company that is doing business with the public. They then have all of their customers and all of their deposits scrutinized to the point where they'll flag things that end up being legitimate.
Can you give me an example?
So a check cashing company is cashing checks for people. And, it turns out that one of the people in there is a drug dealer or money launderer. Then the bank will tell on the business, their customer. Mm. And if the check casher does not have, proper controls in place, they can be liable for that. And yep. It's just the depths that this act and that all the subsequent revisions has gone, it's just ridiculous.
Yeah, it absolutely is. And I guess it's worth pointing out some of these restrictions for people in case they're not aware of them. The cash transaction records, CTR? Their cash transaction report.
Currency transaction report.
That is if you do more than $10,000 or $10,000 or more in cash deposits or withdrawals. And the suspicious activity report can be triggered by any amount as long as it looks suspicious. So if you come in and you do a $5,000 transfer one day, a $5,000 the next day, a $5,000 the next day, they might decide that that's suspicious.
Structuring.
Yeah, they'll decide that structuring in order to avoid the cash transaction report, and they will file a SAR, a suspicious activity report. Am I right about that, Libertarian Banker?
Well, no. Well, the currency transaction report is just for the cash transaction. Then the suspicious activity report is anything that the banker or the teller thinks is suspicious. So, you bring in a couple $1,000 that grandma gave you for your birthday, you might get written up on one of these reports.
Yeah, now there are a lot of these reports filed every single day. I suspect hundreds of thousands, if not several tens of thousands, all across the United States. I mean, there's a lot of people doing a lot of business at banks. So I wonder how much of these the Treasury Department or whoever it is that's looking through them are really paying close attention to.
Well, I'll tell you, the IRS uses them, no doubt, and they have limitless powers where they don't even have to go to a court to garnish your bank account. They can just send us a letter, and banks will gladly comply with it.
What would happen if a bank? What would happen if a bank told the IRS, "No, we're not going to do what you want"?
Yeah, well, you're not going to be a bank any longer, pretty much.
Well, the first step is. Go ahead.
I was going to say, Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies that allow you to anonymize transactions actually might be a good thing for the banks, because then they might have plausible deniability. I didn't know he was doing that. He encrypted his transaction. So,
yeah. So, what would happen though? I mean, if a bank actually said to the IRS, "We don't respond to bureaucrats' letters get a court order or something like that, you know, would the IRS be able to just go to the FDIC, knock on their door and say, hey, Libertarian Bankers Bank said no to us. Can you pull their license or whatever, or pull their insurance?
I honestly don't know. I've never heard of it happening. So
it's
I don't know.
That they're paralyzed in fear.
Right. Well, it's like anything else. The first step to getting a bank that says no is probably getting this library to say no, in a sense. And the more people say no, the more major institutions say no.
I agree. It would be very interesting to see someone try that.
And I'll tell you, a lot of the regulation that comes out also, it incentivizes mergers and things, and banks get bigger and bigger and bigger. And community banks and credit unions and these small institutions that are actually, you know, great to deal with, you know, they get gobbled up and they get, you know, eaten alive by the big bank.
Yeah, that's true. But of course, you know, the fact is, even for a small bank, community organization, there's still a lot of money on the line. And when you've got a big investment, the people who make those investments tend to not want to rock the boat when it comes to the government. And so that's why you see just overall compliance across the board. But it really would be interesting to see a liberty-friendly bank say no to the IRS and see what happened. And document, of course. Document,
record,
video. I'd
love to see it too, but I'd feel bad for all the people who lost their jobs and people who lost their money in the investment and these sorts of things. There's a good reason to be scared of the federal government. It's because they can put you out of business in short order.
Well, then, you know, you go to Switzerland or the Cayman Islands and you can find those.
Well, in Switzerland, they bowed to the U.S. government on this one. The Swiss banks are basically out of the secret bank account business because they, the Swiss government finally just said, look, we can't take the pressure from the United States State Department. And that's it.
What was it? Gandhi said, for a time, tyrannies can seem invisible, are invincible, but in the end, they always fall.
Banker, anything else you want to share
tonight? Thank you for your time tonight.
Thanks.
Guys.
Appreciate the call and the information. Yeah, he's absolutely right. I mean, the bank account is compromised from day one. If the federal government wants to get in there, they're going to get let in, which is why Bitcoin is one of the really important uses for Bitcoin is to take the money out of the hands of the old financial system and put it into your hands to where you are in control of your money. No one can shut down your Bitcoin account. Unless the internet gets turned off, the entirety of the internet, your Bitcoin's going to be there. 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733.
Flu season's on the way, but there are steps you can take now to be prepared, like getting your flu shot. And Walmart makes it simple. Just walk in anytime to get your flu shot from one of our certified pharmacists. No appointment necessary. To make it even easier, we accept most insurance plans. A flu shot's your best shot at staying healthy this flu season. And Walmart can make taking that simple step easier than ever.
Some immunizations may not be available in all locations due to state law restrictions on pharmacist-administered immunizations. Age restrictions may apply.
This week on Geico's Stuff Found in Your Car, we look inside your rear door pocket.
Oh, hey. Yeah, me, the almond. Possibly one of the healthiest snacks, just rolling around in the crumbs of inferior foods. You were too busy to save me, but are you too busy to switch your car insurance to Geico where you could save hundreds of dollars in just 15 minutes? Probably not. Saving money with Geico is awesome. Almonds, on the other hand, are just a superfood. No big deal.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com today.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767.
Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
So I found out the other day that at guns80.com, a lot of people don't get the Ghost AR-15 rifle kits because they're afraid that they won't be able to do the machining work required to drill out and make ready the lower. Well, listen, guys, gals, I am not that good of a machinist, I promise you. But I was able to take a drill press with an XY table and knock this out in about 45 minutes, and in all honesty, mine looks really good. Go get yours. Don't be afraid. It's easy. Guns80.com. Go to guns80.com now.
Attention, all men. Are you urinating more frequently? Do you wake up to urinate? Are you having a slower, weaker stream? Don't ignore the warning signs of your aging prostate. Get your free bottle of Super Beta Prostate. Super Beta Prostate is guaranteed to support a more complete emptying of your bladder, a fuller, stronger stream, and less waking at night to urinate.
Super Beta Prostate is a product that I really like. I endorse it. I use it myself. I was very pleasantly surprised that Super Beta Prostate helped me fairly quickly.
Super Beta Prostate is formulated with a natural plant enzyme called beta-sitosterol. It's so powerful, you'd have to take 100 salt palmetto pills to get the same sterols as just one Super Beta Prostate tablet. Don't ignore the warning signs of your aging prostate. Call now to get your free bottle of Super Beta Prostate. Call 1-800-853-1203. That's 1-800-853-1203. 800-853-1203.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor, period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. Who out there is of the belief that if you don't have anything to hide, what does privacy matter? 855-450-FREE is our number. You want to take the government side here, and or like I guess the Department of Homeland Security, because there's another side, which is the government as well, where there's a library in New Hampshire that is or had been running a Tor node to help protect people's privacy. So you actually have one agency of government versus another agency of government, which I like to see that when that happens. I mean, if the government's going to fight with somebody, it's better they be fighting amongst themselves than against the rest of us out here. So I don't mind it when that does happen. But, you know, if you think that privacy is overrated, I'd love to hear from you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We also have Skype. You can Skype in here at username lrn.fm. Mark, you're getting ready for a journey to Vegas in about 6 weeks.
Yeah, I sure am. It's October the 29th and 30th at the beautiful D Hotel in downtown Las Vegas. And it's the Bitcoin Investor Conference. There's going to be some great speakers there. Go check out the speaker list at bitcoininvestor.com. Trace Mayer, Dr. Stephanie Murphy there on the list. As am I, I'll be doing a little emceeing as well as doing Free Talk Live at the event. So you don't want to miss it. It's bitcoininvestor.com. You can still get early bird pricing, and it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm excited. Bitcoininvestor.com.
Bitcoininvestor.com.
First one ever, by the way. I mean, I can't express how important it is if you can go to a first convention to do that, because if this sounds like a good idea to you to be a Bitcoin investor, or maybe you already are, or you want to be one or whatever.
This is where the venture capitalists are going to be floating around, right?
This is where, you know, this is a ground floor thing. And if you are going to be on the ground floor of a convention, that's a good thing, because if you're planning on going back the next year, then you know everybody at year number two and you're not the new guy in the building. And I think it's an important thing to go to these if you can go to a first year event. Bitcoininvestor.com. Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. The FBI director claiming that if you think the Tor and the dark web is going to conceal you, that you are kidding yourself. And the story is coming from TheIntercept.com, where security experts are questioning the FBI's tough talk here. In fact, the Edward Snowden leaks, one of them from the NSA whistleblower, It's actually a document from the NSA that he leaked entitled Tor Stinks. And in that document, they say they will never be able to de-anonymize all Tor users all the time. Now, of course, how many they can de-anonymize at once or whatever, we don't know. They certainly did do some sort of magic to find the Silk Road's server, and we still don't know how that happened. That information was not revealed during the trial of Ross Ulbricht. So maybe there is some sort of method that they have that they can use to de-anonymize someone on Tor, but they certainly are even admitting here in their own document that they cannot de-anonymize and say they will never be able to de-anonymize all Tor users all the time.
Well, it's like Sun Tzu said, the way of war is deception, and this is an institution that thinks it's perpetually at war, so it's going to deceive whoever it can get away with deceiving. So you can't believe a thing they say.
Well, in the case of the government, you're right. You generally can't believe a thing they say. But in this case, this is a leaked document from the NSA, which they didn't expect was going to go public. So this was their own internal opinion.
Did they really call it Tor Stinks?
Yes.
Called it that? The FBI called it that.
Yeah, actually, there's another story here.
We're paying them how much to come up with that brilliant use of the English language?
Well, at least it encapsulates the article.
Oh, yeah, at least it wasn't, indecipherable bureaucraties.
I've got a little bit more detail on the Tor Stink story. We can talk a little bit about that here in a moment. But so you've got two claims from the government to compare here. One is the internal document that was not intended for release, where they're saying that they're basically flummoxed by Tor to some extent. And then the other one is the FBI's public statement saying, the tough talk statement saying, we're going to get you guys. You can't hide from us on Tor. Micah Lee wrote in The Intercept in July about leaked emails from a spyware maker, the Hacking Team, indicating that the company had sold the FBI a way to monitor Tor browser traffic from a target already infected with Hacking Team malware. So, okay, sure, if you've got a hacked piece of software on your computer that was placed there by this Hacking Team and you're using Tor, then they could find you.
You're not reading Tor, you're screen scraping. You're taking pictures of the person's typing, basically.
Didn't a lot of people have this hacked hardware that in their setup? Because it isn't necessarily just your computer that it could be. It could be your router, it could be your modem, it could be a whole variety of things.
No,
right?
No, this was Hacking Team. It's a spyware maker. It's software that would be on your computer.
Okay.
So don't install the stuff but downloaded from the porn site. You'll be all right.
Weren't U.S. intelligence agencies hijacking shipments of hardware and putting things in there?
There was a story a while back about certain hard drives. There was something in the boot sector on the hard drive that was supposedly some questionable software. But there was no evidence that was done on any kind of wide scale. The hardware manufacturers claimed that they were not involved in that. So it may have been that they did plant something on certain drives, but by no means is that a system-wide or a product-wide
problem. This seemed like a lot of work.
The FBI famously unmasked and arrested the operator of the Tor-enabled drug marketplace Silk Road, not by cracking Tor, but by chasing other clues, including the sloppy reuse of aliases, and by physically surveilling the operator as he logged in and out of his dark web website. But Comey seems to be implying, this is the head of the FBI, that the FBI has some sort of across-the-board ability to see who's looking at what on the Tor network. Cryptography expert Bruce Schneier said Comey's statements should not be taken at face value. He said that given previous false public statements by intelligence officials, the truth value is irrelevant, he said. We certainly know that Tor has been broken in the past using specific exploits. Do they have a blanket attack or is it posturing? Who knows, he added. It's certainly good posturing. And I would say that it's posturing. This is tough talk. It's nothing more than tough talk.
Yeah.
If they actually had a way to monitor all Tor traffic or identify Tor users on some sort of regular, reliable basis, you'd see arrests happening.
Well, again, that's partly because the federal government spends so much time investigating people before arresting them in many cases.
And that's
true. They may have cracked it a year ago, and then there'd be a delay before they arrest anyone.
Well, that could very well be true, Dave, and maybe there will be a huge swath of arrests that come one of these days, but call me skeptical about this.
Yeah, I'm skeptical too. I'm also skeptical as to whether Tor is going to protect me.
Sure. There's thousands of drugs right now. If you go on to whatever, I know Agra shut down recently. Silk Road's been taken down. So there are more drug markets now than there have ever been, but some of them aren't as established. If you go on some of these marketplaces, you'll find anywhere from 6,000 to 10,000 drug listings. There are probably a few hundred people right now who are doing business on these services, making money hand over fist, and you know the FBI has done nothing about that. And the other thing I would add, Dave, to what you said there about trusting Tor, you don't have to just trust Tor. You can also combine Tor with PGP, Pretty Good Privacy, which is a relatively well-established privacy tool on the internet. On these drug marketplaces, for instance, when an order is placed, the better drug marketplaces will require you to send your address to the seller with PGP encryption. So then only the seller is able to actually read your address. Of course, if the seller's an FBI agent, you have a problem. But it's Free Talk Live. 855-450-FREE.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor recommended Say Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com. The new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be The Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, "It's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel." Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Toll free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We go to your phone calls. Coming up here, I want you to also know one of the ways to protect your privacy, and it's a darn good one. It's also very affordable on the internet, is ProXPN. So let's say you're not so sure about this Tor thing.
Let's say that.
Yeah. And you can actually use Tor through ProXPN for an additional layer of privacy, because ProXPN actually encrypts all your internet traffic, so your own internet service provider will not know what you're doing online. Plus, ProXPN doesn't log any of your activities on their servers, so you can go to proxpn.com and get signed up with code FTL50. You'll save 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you buy the annual account with code FTL50. Now, they use OpenVPN. This is the gold standard of network encryption. They've got apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and Linux support as well. So one of the ways they took down Ross Ulbricht was, once they had an idea of who might be Dread Pirate Roberts on the Silk Road, they actually monitored his home internet account, and they could see when he was going on to Tor. Now, they didn't know what he was doing necessarily when he went on to Tor, but by monitoring the ports that he was using on his home internet connection, they could see that, oh, he's on Tor. Oh, he's logged off of Tor. Oh, look, he just walked out of his house. Okay, so, you know, they kind of put two and two together or whatever. If Ross was using ProXPN, then they wouldn't have been able to monitor his home internet connection. So, you know, using ProXPN adds an extra level of privacy to you that you just normally don't have. And you can connect to their servers all around the world, which they have more now than ever before, giving you greater speed and security. And with our discount code FTL50, it can end up being cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee. So whatever your reasons for getting privacy, ProXPN is a big help. ProXPN.com, code FTL50. Take back the privacy. That is your right. And, you know, privacy isn't about drugs and sex necessarily. Privacy is about people not needing to know your business, whatever it is. And maybe it is your business. Maybe you're transferring important business files from one point to another. You know, business secrets, the KFC secret recipe. Would you want to trust that to your regular internet connection?
Having a business, there's just things that you need to not tell people, right? I mean,
yeah, exactly.
you don't tell people the name of your bank account numbers and you know, things like that. You just don't do that stuff.
Right. Privacy matters. And anybody that says that Tor's only about illegal activity is wrong. We just get to find out about how they busted Tor, or you know what, the details about the feds cracking Tor through looking at them investigating people who were committing criminal acts. So that's why we know so much about, you know, Ross Ulbricht and all that. Let's go to your phone calls and thoughts here. I do have the Tor presentation, or the Tor stinks presentation. I'll link to that on our Facebook and Twitter so you can take a look at it. It's not worth reading on the air. It's very technical. But let's go to your calls and thoughts here. We've got Doug. He's in Illinois. And Doug, you're on listening via TuneIn.
Yeah, about a week ago, my uncle and I got into a whole debate about what you're talking about, the government and the internet. I think that the government, they've done a wonderful job with their propaganda that they're giving to people. They've really fooled a lot of people. When you log on to the internet, you have your internet traffic become fiber optic light on the backbone of the internet, like a tier one company for AT&T. And what they found, what Glenn Greenwald brought forward, had been that they're actually duplicating that light, meaning that you have the light continue and the internet traffic continue to where it should go, But then the government, they're getting a duplicate light of it, too, and they're picking up all the traffic. I think that they're combining that they're getting all the traffic. They're holding it for a short period of time. They're going through it. You know, maybe they'll put in, you know, look for a particular word. You know, maybe terror, maybe attack, or, you know, and then they're getting more traffic in and going through that. You know, but I find it funny the people in America that believe that, you know, an internet packet will have like a red flag on it, and they're only taking that one out of the conveyor belt. It don't work like that, you know.
Yeah, certainly the NSA is sucking up as much data as they possibly can.
They're sucking all the water out of a Utah town to cool their computers, aren't they?
That's true, from what I understand. Yeah.
Can't they put it back just one?
Right, but what they found are that each fiber optic line, each node, like they have one coming in from Japan, but not only like in California and New York and Florida, but within the interior of the country, at each node, they're diverting the internet traffic. They're diverting the light. They're making a duplicate of it, and they're picking all that up. Well, if you're only going after people that are involved in terror, why would you be doing that? You know, it don't add up.
Well, that's because they want to know everything about everybody as much as they can possibly.
Yeah, that's not why they're doing it. They're doing it so they can get dirt on judges, dirt on library directors that might fight them on tour, dirt on anyone they can fight. Dirt on anyone that might fight them, who's becomes a central point of interest later.
Doug, anything else you want to share?
I find it incredible. I mean, to be blunt, I really find the American people dumb. I mean, they really are. I mean, including, I'm not trying to call my family member completely dumb, but they're duped. You know what I mean?
They're deceived.
They're buying the propaganda. I mean, I watched a program on Frontline. I think it had been on Frontline in North Korea. And them people are duped into thinking that they live in a country better than any on the planet. And they really actually believe it. And they're fed propaganda about how the country will be improving in a month or two, and time after time after time. And the people believe it. And
well, great leader gave.
They can't pull that here.
Great leader gave us this 8286 computer that no one else in the world has anything as good.
Yeah, you know, I think the other thing is they're scared, so it's easy to dupe somebody if they're afraid. And so if people are afraid of the idea of terrorists or bad drug dealers or whatever, then they're more likely to hand over whatever few freedoms they have left and to the government with the demand of protect us, keep us safe, we'll do anything, you know. And it's really sad. You can see this on display when they interview people about the TSA at the airports, where even though that we know that the TSA is completely useless or near to completely useless at actually catching things, their own tests show them at like 90% failure rate, 90 to 100%, I think, the more recent ones that leaked out. So we know that it's just a joke and it's security theater, but not all the Americans are paying attention to those news stories. So
it's amazing how many they aren't. You know, I've stood in a line just recently with somebody who said, "I'll take care of I'll do anything as long as we're safe on this airplane."
Yeah, and they will say things like that.
I mean,
yeah, go ahead.
They were going after Dr. Martin Luther King. We know that. We know that the government, that they were doing everything that they could. They were monitoring him. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can imagine the tool that they have here and the power that they have. Even if they're not going to do anything with it right away, later on down the road, we could be in a lot of trouble, you know?
I mean, the FBI, I think, had admitted, or maybe it was Detroit Police. I forget who it was, but one of the cop bureaucrats out there admitted that they were infiltrating the Quakers. I mean, they were infiltrating Quaker meetings.
It was the FBI,
yeah. Like, you know, as of, was that during 2011? Was that during the...
I could look it up, but it's happened more than once.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's just ridiculous. They've got these people everywhere. Hey, thanks, Doug, for your call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. D is on the line in California.
Quaker meetings, by the way, is Quaker church, because they don't call it church. They think it's presumptuous to call your building a church when the whole body of Christianity is called the church.
Right, well, yeah, exactly. D is in California. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, D.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
You're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just have one quick thing, and I'll address what you guys are talking about now. The other day, you guys had a semantic argument with another caller about ISIS and ISIL and everything. But in the Middle East, they actually call them Daesh, which is completely, you know, they don't go around calling them ISIS.
Mm-hmm.
They actually call them Daesh, and off the top of my head, I can't think of what it's called. But ISIS is, you know, the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria, and now as they're spreading, they're called, you know, the Islamic State in Iraq and in the Levant, which is the whole area. But I haven't heard anything you guys have been talking about tonight, but talking about right now, just the last caller addressed between internet security as well as just the general population and how they feel safe. It's amazing to me, yeah, just people don't really pay attention to the news very often, the general population. I found out, at least in my job, talking to people, they think of the government as, you know, these high society of people of, you know, they're almost gods, you know, among us.
You'd think they would know better than that. I actually have a story about this. If you want, stand by, D. We'll bring it back. 855-450-FREE about people's opinions about government bureaucrats from all the way from military officers to congressmen. It's kind of interesting. Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-719-9349. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-719-9349. That's 1-800-719-9349. 1-800-719-9349.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Female and had a heart attack in 2005. This is Alice from New Jersey. I still get angina, even with four stents. I was taking Nitro two or three times a week. The very first day after taking Heart and Body Extract, the chest pain was gone. Now I don't wear a Nitro patch.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at HBExtract.com.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't pick on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Mike Stenerson for Midas Resources. At no time in history have precious metals been more important, certainly not in my 22 years in the industry. The dollar has lost over 90% of its value in the last 60 years. No fiat currency has ever survived the government printing presses. Ours is not immune. The time is now to be proactive. 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Anything tied to the dollar is at risk. CDs, annuities, 401ks, IRAs, stocks, bonds, you name it, so decide. Do you want to leave a legacy of wealth or debt for your family? The choice is yours. Call me at 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Be proactive, not reactive. Call 1-800-686-2237, extension 116.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24-7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Mm-hmm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Skype username here, lrn.fm, talking about privacy and the claims that the federal government, specifically the FBI, is making that they have somehow compromised Tor. At least that's the tough talk from the head of the FBI, Director James Comey, saying that criminals who think they can invade or evade law enforcement using the dark web and the Tor network are kidding themselves. But of course, while they're supposedly kidding themselves, there are all manner of drugs being sold and distributed online via these underground marketplaces like the Silk Road and Agra, which are both actually shut down at this point. But nonetheless, there's a lot of business being done. There are, I don't know, a dozen or so different drug market sites, maybe even more than that, some more popular than others. And the FBI certainly hasn't stopped them. The FBI didn't shut down Agra, by the way. Agra operated until they decided to close their doors. And
they got rich enough?
they claim it was actually a security issue, Mark. Their recent release on their site where they actually allowed their users to withdraw their funds. Normally when the Tor websites, the underground marketplaces...
Right, everybody's just screwed, right? Yeah. When they shut down, they're gone.
Right, usually if a Tor marketplace shuts down, they shut down under two different circumstances. One, they get raided. Two, they just take people's money and close the doors.
Right.
So in Agra's case, they actually gave people notice and said, look, we're shutting down for a time period. We don't know how long. We've got security issues and we want to address them properly. And so remove your money. And they did. Which is, you know, they deserve a lot of credit for that. And so Agra was basically put online after the first Silk Road takedown. So they've been around, they had been around for two solid years of operation and had become the number one underground marketplace on the dark web. The FBI didn't stop them. So whatever system they've got for de-anonymizing Tor traffic is not a perfect system, it seems. Let's go back to your calls and thoughts. D was calling in to comment on ISIS, the Middle East, terrorism, or whatever. D, go ahead. You didn't have enough time in the previous segment, so go ahead with your thoughts.
Oh, no, I just, just harping back to what we were talking about before the break. Yeah, it's just, it's incredible to me, you know, people. And I feel like the country is almost getting divided right now with people on the left who want Sanders, who want more government. They want, you know, they look at the government and love it. They want the government.
Well, people on the right look at the government and love it, too.
Yeah, what do you call all those military, you know, pro-military people?
No, exactly. I feel like on the right, they say they want less government, but on the other hand, they want huge militarized bureaucracies with the border wall.
And a wall.
They want to, they keep saying, oh, take all the soldiers from the Middle East and put them at the border. You know, they want more police control.
Right.
You know, this complete, almost really just a fascist status mentality, you know, and they want law and order, you know, and all this.
In America's defense, okay, so I think that some people like Bernie Sanders, not because of all the free stuff he's offering, and by the way, I'm running for president and you can vote for me, I will give you double the free stuff that Bernie Sanders will. But it's not because of the free stuff he's offering, just because he seems like an authentic guy who's stuck with his principles up till now. He's not your everyday politician, and so they like him for that reason. And I think to some extent that they like Trump for the same reason. Trump is willing to tell everybody to go to hell. And there are a lot of people that are just been, they feel like they've been pushed so far by the government, you know, local, state, federal, that they just want to tell everybody to go to hell, and Donald Trump is giving them that voice. And it's not really about more government. It's just about frustration and upset.
No, exactly. And I agree. I think Trump is just a big middle finger to, you know, all the Republicans in the Beltway and everything like that. And that's why I think people latch on to him. He just says whatever he says. And no one can trash talk Trump. Anytime one of the politicians one of their very calculated, you know, beats against Trump, Trump just comes out and just destroys them. And I think people like that. He just, you know, gives them right back to it. But what Trump's proposing, and I think will happen, is more government in the sense of the wall. He wants to, who knows what his plan is with illegal immigrants. He keeps saying, well, you know, they'll be gone. Is he going to go to people's homes and raid and start taking illegal immigrants and everything out? And it's crazy. So I agree on the side of Trump of, you know, we need a
not a political person in office, but with some of the policies it's going to be, who knows what's going to happen. But, you know, no matter who gets elected, and he won't get elected, I don't think, obviously, it's just going to be the same thing. You know, same person, same crap, different day. But, I don't know. I just feel it's just funny to me at work when I hear people, it's either they're almost Trump, you know, and they say, oh, illegal immigrants, you know, we need to get them, this and that. Or they're on the other side where, you know, they go, well, I want my $15 an hour. When, you know,
yeah, everybody wants something from the government. Donald. Yeah, I think you're spot on with your assessment.
Take care of me.
D, thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Apparently, people just aren't disappointed enough with the government yet. They still believe that they can sculpt it and mold it in the way that the vision that they have for it, that this next batch of politicians, they're the ones we've been waiting for our entire lives.
Well, no, they just want they have some idea about how the government can function more efficiently, and they're probably right. Like, if you gave the control of the government over to, you know, somebody with a good idea, they could probably do a good job in making it function more efficiently. However, they aren't the one who's going to implement it. It's going to be given to a bunch of government bureaucrats who have already been in place for a decade or more, and they're going to be told, hey, make this work. And, you know, all the joy has been sucked out of their life already. They're not going to make that happen. You can't make the government do what you want it to do.
Chris Sughoian, the chief technologist for the American Civil Liberties Union, told The Intercept that the FBI director's claims, the tough talk about how they're going to get all you Tor users, all you people doing illegal things on the internet, that they can see what you're doing, you better look out. He says it's not credible. Quote, the FBI director continues to ignore the consensus of the computer security community when we say there is no way to build a secure backdoor for the government. If he continues to ignore experts on this issue, why should we believe what he has to say on something as equally technical as the security of the Tor network? He has every incentive to bluff. And it shouldn't be a surprise that the government would lie to you about this. We know that's what the NSA did when they were caught with their pants down, caught red-handed by the various different releases from Edward Snowden. Mm-hmm. The NSA director got on, you know, public television and just lied, and then Ed Snowden revealed more information that proved that he lied, and then he lied again, and then more information revealed that he lied again. So don't believe for a moment that the FBI director wouldn't do the exact same thing. Comey has recently been making headlines, this from TheIntercept.com, for alleging, also without evidence, that he is able, or rather, that he is increasingly unable to track criminal conduct online due to end-to-end encryption. He's been insisting that tech companies come up with a system that's secure to everyone except for law enforcement. This is what I was talking about earlier, where Google and Apple have phone-level encryption now, apparently. I've not seen it myself, but this is what I understand, that their newer operating systems have come out with the option to just encrypt your entire phone. And he's been demanding that they put a back door in. So, you know, does he want it both ways here? He says on one hand that they're mad because the tech companies are putting encryption on their devices. But on the other hand, he's claiming this encrypted system, they have they've bested it. So, you know, what's the truth?
Yeah, what's the truth? Indeed. You don't need to worry about them having these back doors if you already have it beat.
He has, again, been insisting that they come up with this backdoor, and something that tech experts say is flatly impossible. Sughoian notes that the Tor browser's new automatic security updates means the FBI can no longer reliably hack large numbers of Tor users with public security exploits for which patches exist. Tor is not perfect, for sure, writes the ACLU guy. He says, but it's one of the best tools we have to protect privacy online, largely because researchers have
been... shouldn't not use protection because it's not perfect. That's like saying you shouldn't wear
a condom on
because it's only 99.whatever%
exactly
effective. Silly.
One of the best tools, he says, because researchers have been beating it up, finding and fixing flaws in it for a decade, and much of this research was supported by the U.S. government. The Tor project is an amazing thing. You should look into it if you care about privacy online. And of course, like I said, it can be combined with other privacy measures like PGP. And Mark, you and I were talking off the air about this, and I mentioned, and I didn't say this on the air, but If you're going to be using PGP for privacy purposes on things like darknets or whatever, don't use your personal PGP for that. You can make a new PGP key just for your darknet personality.
Yeah,
you
that's a good idea.
You don't want to sign it with Mark at freetalklive.com's PGP key.
Thank God I don't mess around with any of this stuff. Otherwise, I'd be jail someplace.
Yeah, well, one of the things the NSA said about that's good about Tor is when the users screw up.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Ricky LeBlanc, admitted in Mass only. Sokolov Law, LLC, Chestnut Hill, Mass. Ken Levin, responsible attorney in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Greg Hobby, New Jersey. The choice of lawyer is an important decision that should not be based solely upon advertisements. While this firm maintains joint responsibility, most cases of this type are referred to other attorneys for principal responsibility. If you know what mesothelioma is, you or someone you love has likely been impacted by this devastating cancer. You may be entitled to compensation. Call Sokolov Law today. 1-800-218-HELP. The only known cause of mesothelioma is asbestos exposure. Thousands of hardworking men and women, including many U.S. veterans and industrial workers, have been diagnosed with mesothelioma because manufacturers knew the dangers but put profits ahead of people. An estimated $30 billion in court-ordered trusts has been set aside to pay money to asbestos victims. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma, call now. You may be entitled to receive compensation without ever going to court or filing a lawsuit. Call for a free legal consultation at 1-800-218-HELP. That's 1-800-218-HELP.
Listening to GCN, the world leader in independent talk radio.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. Wildfires continue to burn the parched timber and brush of California. It's also displacing at least 23,000 people, some of whom are losing everything they had.
We literally had law enforcement officers and firefighters going house to house as the flaming front was coming through, pulling people out and getting them to safety. We had individuals walking down streets after their homes had burned, after their cars had burned, and had no place to go.
That's Cal Fire Chief Ken Pimlott. At least one person has died in that blaze in California's Napa Valley. A second massive blaze less than 200 miles away destroyed 135 homes as it spread through Amador and Calaveras counties in the Sierra Nevada. Cleveland, Mississippi Sheriff Charles Bingham says authorities are searching for a suspect in today's fatal shooting of Delta State University history professor Ethan Schmidt.
Mr. Shannon Lamb, we identified him as a person of interest. At this time, we're going to upgrade him to a suspect. We're actively pursuing Mr. Lamb at this moment. We have information that we're following up on. We have leads that we're following up on.
Lamb is also suspected in the murder of 41-year-old Amy Prentice at her home in Goshen, Mississippi. The Pentagon says there are signs that Russia intends to establish an air operations base at a Syrian airport.
What we're seeing is that airport is being readied to be used as a forward airbase.
Pentagon spokesman Captain Jeff Davis, who says Russia's in the midst of a steady military buildup there, although no fighter jets or helicopters have arrived yet. U.S. officials want to be sure that any Russian air operations don't conflict with U.S. and coalition airstrikes that are being carried out in other parts of Syria against Islamic State targets. On Wall Street, the Dow down by 62 points, the NASDAQ dropped 16, the S&P lower by 8, oil down to $44 a barrel. More on these stories at townhall.com.
There are times when people need a little extra money, honest, hardworking people, and some banks don't always make it fast or easy. But finally, there's a company who gets it, who could help my listeners that need it. Avant. You simply go to avantoffer.com on your computer or phone to check your rate risk-free with no effect on your FICO score. Complete your application in minutes and the funds could be in your account as soon as tomorrow. If any of my listeners need a loan between $1,000 and $35,000, go to avantoffer.com. Avant will give you a $50 Amazon.com gift card after you make your first payment on time. For this offer and to check your rate risk-free, go to avantoffer.com and enter promo code BORROW. That's AVANTOffer.com, promo code BORROW, avantoffer.com, promo code BORROW. Loans made by WebBank and by affiliates of Avant Incorporated. California loans offered by Avant are made under finance lenders license number 603K124. Funds are generally deposited via ACH for delivery next business day. If approved by 4:30 p.m. Central Time, Monday through Friday. Amazon is not a sponsor of this promotion. Other restrictions apply. See website for details.
Less than 2 days before the next Republican primary debate, a new poll shows a continuing surge for the GOP frontrunners.
Donald Trump and Ben Carson continue to increase their leads over the rest of the GOP field, while support for the Democrats' frontrunner Hillary Rodham Clinton has dropped below 50% for the first time. That according to a just-released Washington Post ABC poll, which shows Trump polling at 33% of Republican-leaning voters and Carson closing the gap at 20%, all the other GOP contenders register in the single digits.
That's Capitol Hill correspondent Wally Hines reporting. Authorities are offering some details on how a 77-year-old man survived for 3 nights and 4 days in the rugged Utah wilderness. They say Christian Herrera drank water from streams and slept next to brush to stay warm in temperatures that dipped into the 30s. He was found yesterday afternoon. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. OPEC has cut its oil production forecast for countries like the U.S. that are not members of the cartel. Correspondent Jeremy House has the details.
The group says it lowered its forecast for daily oil supply growth this year from non-member states by 72,000 barrels a day to 880,000 due to lower than anticipated output in the U.S. For 2016, it trimmed its forecast by 110,000 barrels to 160,000. The cartel also hiked its forecast for global demand growth this year by about 84,000 barrels a day to 1.46 million and by 50,000 to 1.29 million barrels for 2016. Jeremy House reporting.
Several European countries are beefing up border controls on coiling razor wire and steel mesh. Austria, the Netherlands, the Czech Republic, and Slovakia are all joining Germany in tightening border controls in the wake of the massive migration from the Middle East. More on these stories at townhall.com.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Free Talk Live.
Free Talk Live. Dial on in here to join the program and bring up whatever's on your mind. We've been talking about privacy, and that's, I think, an important issue these days, now more so than ever, with the federal government becoming more and more invasive into every single aspect of our digital lives. Of course, there are specific tools that you can use to protect yourself. And I think it's, you know, when you have a discussion about privacy, it should behoove us to go over some of the basics on how to protect yourself. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
So privacy is something, and I want to talk about it from just a larger perspective here for a moment, because we did zero in earlier on some of the ridiculous claims being made by the FBI about how they can crack Tor, and I don't believe that, neither do the security experts. But, you know, as a larger issue, privacy is an important thing because, well, you know, you don't want to necessarily give everybody every bit of data about your life or your business or, you know, the secrets you might have come across. Maybe you work for the government and you've discovered things that are untoward, that they are inappropriate, that going on within the government bureaucracy. But you know what they've done to Edward Snowden. So maybe you want to release some information in a private manner. You know, there's all kinds of reasons why privacy is important to people. But you do have to go through a certain level of effort to protect yourself. And there are things that you can do. We already talked about ProXPN, which you can use to encrypt your internet connection. Tor, on top of that, gives you anonymity as well. So those are two basic things you can use with pretty much any computer system. And in addition, there are some tools that you might want to use for your cell phone, like Text Secure. If you text to somebody who also has Text Secure, which is a free program, then that will encrypt your text messages. Because right now, if you're just texting, and you know, certainly younger people are very big into texting.
Yeah.
They're texting more so than calling. In fact, young millennials, for instance, prefer texting to a phone call. They'll be irritated if you call them.
Remember the story we read that said that people experience anxiety attacks over having to leave phone messages, voicemail messages?
Young people are doing that,
young
right?
people, generally, you know, they're going into jobs where they have to answer a telephone and
not prepared for it.
A message, and right. they don't have, you know, like they don't have the life skills at this point to deal with it. Another yeah. thing that school's not teaching them.
So protect yourself on the text world by using Text Secure because it encrypts your text communications. Otherwise, any cop who wants to can go and subpoena the text messages from your cell phone provider, and they'll just provide them. You know, anybody can go and read that. Your cell phone provider can pull all of that data. It's no problem. But if it's encrypted, then it's useless.
Well, there's this military concept that you don't focus too much on defense, though. The offense is really ultimately more important.
What does that mean in this context?
Well, encryption is a defensive thing. It's like you're trying to be safe at every point when mm-hmm. instead you should be focusing on the source of your problems and going after it in some way, some constructive, nonviolent way. I like this quote from Churchill. He's talking about how Napoleon used this concept. He said, quote, "We see Napoleon before his battles, grasping for every man he can reach, neglecting no resource, however small, cheerfully accepting risks at other points." Unquote. The thing is, you denude your defenses so that you can have your offense. Does that make sense? If you spend all your time working up your defenses on your computer, well, you're not protesting. You're not.
It doesn't take that much time. So that's the nice thing about these tools that we have, Dave. Is the programmers are the ones spending the time on this. The geeks who have programmed, Tor and Text Secure and these other tools, PGP. That work's been done and it's being improved upon over time. But that's what they are doing. And it's certainly defenses are important. You're not acknowledging that they're not. But, you know, not everybody can take down the federal government with what they're doing, right? Like, you know, even if we are to use offense, some sort of peaceful offense, the federal government's not going to go away tomorrow and they're not going to stop arresting people tomorrow. But tomorrow, you can implement all of these technologies that we're talking about in a matter of an hour. I mean, this isn't a huge time-consuming activity.
And then possibly at the end of that point, have a great false sense of security.
Well, that's the thing. I don't think that you should have a true sense of security with any of these measures. I mean, to a dedicated attacker, you can be taken down. I mean, whether it's you know, your internet security or your home locks on your front door, to anybody that, you know, is dedicated with the time and the effort necessary, they're going to get through your lock, whether it's they've got a bump key or they know how to pick a lock or whatever. You know, you can install more complicated locks, but the expert who knows how to get through those is going to be able to get them. So, no, you shouldn't have a false sense of security, and you should always be wary of the things that you're communicating.
Dave, I heard an analogy at one point analogizing the security that we have on computers to the invention of the crossbow. So before the crossbow, you essentially had warriors and peasants. And up until that point, essentially a peasant couldn't wield a warrior's weapon, and a warrior didn't bother his, with the job of peasantry. Obviously, there were people who fought in militaries and these sorts of things, but they still weren't as qualified as the guy with the sword. And the crossbow leveled the playing field, at least for one shot, for the peasant to the noble. And that was what their analogy was with essentially this encryption. Up until this point, the expensive computing stuff was on the side of the government. Well, now we have defenses that are just that good, and that's why you should employ them. Although I must admit, I don't employ them all.
There's the other fact. And of course, I deploy some too. I'm not an unbeliever in the concept, but. The other factor is just that there's always some other way for them to get you. It's just like that Ralph Peters novel where the Americans have stealth bombers. They've sent them to South Africa to help protect Zaire or something like that. The South Africans just hit the stealth bombers while they're on the ground.
Well, no, there's no doubt.
And it's just there's always something like that they can do.
There's no doubt. Yeah. If they want to get you, they're going to get you. They'll just manufacture the evidence. I mean, there are some solid allegations that the evidence in the Silk Road case was falsified in a lot of different ways. I mean, we already know that two of the agents who were involved in the takedown of the Silk Road, this underground drug marketplace that was so infamous, that they were corrupt. And they were funneling Bitcoin into their own personal accounts, and they were also lying to Ross, and they were doing all manner of things that were, you know, really questionable activities. So, you know, these systems, you certainly can't necessarily guarantee that they're going to be safe, but using them is going to make you likely safer than somebody who doesn't use these systems. And they don't take a lot of time to implement. If you want to download TechSecure for your phone, it's just like any other app. You just download it, install it, and then at that point, anyone else that has TechSecure, you're linked up with that person. You're encrypted.
But it's kidding. It was like, for instance, I use a VPN, and you know, I'm glad it's good, but it takes extra time every time I use it. It's the good one. It's designed. Yep. It's said to be the best in the country in terms of ratings. But it does. It simply does not. It does not deliver something for nothing. It's not only costing me money. It's costing me time. Yep. And there's still a place for it. But it's just we've got to put these things in context. They're sure not cure-alls.
Well, I agree with that. They're not cure-alls. And regarding VPNs, personally, I find that the least trustworthy privacy protection. I think that, you know, if some government comes to a VPN and says, we want to monitor Dave Ridley's account, they're probably going to do it. So I would be very, very cautious about trusting the VPN's claims there. You want to use additional security measures on top of that for ultra-private, you know, things that you need to accomplish. So TechSecure is a good one for texting. TechSecure is also open source, so it's also important to use systems that are open source so you can feel more secure about it because you know that the source is open, so therefore it can be audited, which means that other people can go in and they can look at the code to make sure that it's not actually, in point of fact, the NSA who is running the system or who has programmed the tool in the first place. And there's also another one that the TechSecure makers have made called Red Phone, which encrypts your voice communications for your phone. These are two excellent apps, and they're both completely free, and I believe they're available for both iPhone and Android. Maybe you've got a favorite encryption app that
Telegram.
You want to share. Telegram has some question marks, Mark, as far as it being particularly
it's
secure.
Easy to use.
You are using, well, that's the thing. With the trade-off between easy, you usually don't get as much security. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
If you own a business, you know incorporating can be a smart way to protect yourself and your assets. So the question is, why haven't you incorporated your business yet?
My business? It's too small.
Wrong. No matter how small your business, you run the risk of losing all your personal assets, your car, your home, even your entire life savings if you're not incorporated.
Incorporating is very complicated.
Actually, incorporating is easy and fast. You can do it in just 10 minutes. Call now for your free guide from incorporate.com. 1-800-945-8645.
I need a lawyer to incorporate. That's really expensive.
You don't need a lawyer, and we don't offer legal or financial advice.
Incorporate.com is a service company whose only mission is helping people like you incorporate safely, easily, and quickly. Find out how simple it is to protect your family and personal assets by incorporating. Call now for your free guide. 1-800-945-8645. 1-800-945-8645. That's 1-800-945-8645.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Have you ever felt like the United States government knows way too much about your financial affairs? I continue to hear stories about property seizures, frozen bank accounts, confiscation of stocks and bonds. It makes me wonder if the U.S. citizen will ever again have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Unfortunately, with the Drug and Money Laundering Act, the IRS Revenue Ruling 6045 of 1984, and the Trading with the Enemy Act and Franklin D. Roosevelt's Executive Order of 1933, some precious metal holdings are subject to government intervention. For this reason, Midas Resources has prepared a report explaining the boundaries of trading precious metals privately. Whether if you have any intention of trading with Midas Resources or not, I have instructed my representatives to give this report out free. Call for your free copy at 1-800-686-2237. When investing, always proceed with caution. Again, call 1-800-686-2237. Exercise your legal right to trade metals privately. 1-800-686-2237.
So I found out the other day that at guns80.com, a lot of people don't get the Ghost AR-15 rifle kits because they're afraid that they won't be able to do the machining work required to drill out and make ready the lower. Well, listen, guys, gals, I am not that good of a machinist, I promise you. But I was able to take a drill press with an XY table and knock this out in about 45 minutes, and in all honesty, mine looks really good. Go get yours, don't be afraid, it's easy. Guns80.com, go to guns80.com now.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! It's Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here and bring up anything that you want to share with us. Discussing security and privacy, and is it possible to go too far with it? I would say that you can certainly go a little overboard, but better safer than sorry, although Dave Ridley is here from RidleyReport.com. And if you haven't checked out Dave's work, he does some great videos on YouTube. In fact, he's the number two most viewed, or most subscribed to, I believe, channel of the New Hampshire news channels on YouTube. Is that right, Dave?
It's a little more complicated than that. I am basically the number two overall channel, and some people would rate me as number one, but I can't really make that claim because it's just too close to call.
I would rate you as number one, and I think you had more views than did the WMUR, which is the local news channel.
I don't think so. I may get more views per video, but I don't have more views overall, I don't think.
Okay, I'll have to check the statistics again. But anyway, you do great work. You're kind of a window into the world of the activism, some of the activism, because you can't be everywhere.
That's really not what I am anymore.
Really?
I'm more the tool of the activist's revenge.
What do you mean by that?
In the sense that I go and ambush interview politicians about bad things they've done.
So you're not actually going
That's
to...
That's mostly what I do now.
You're not really reporting on activist-y things
I don't
anymore?
Report on activists much anymore. I mean, there's some of that already being done. And also, I don't have a free hand in reporting on activists because I'm too close to too many of the activists, you know?
I see.
It's like if you say something, someone's like, well, wait, you got that information. You were at my dinner table when you got that information. You can't say that. And I can't keep track of what I got at the dinner table and what I got off of, you know, listening to Free Talk Live or something like that. So I just don't focus as much on activists anymore. But if you're an activist, you got something really unusual and interesting to tell me, then, you know, I might get a video of that.
Sometimes you critique other activists as well. I've been critiqued by you.
Well, I do that still, actually, yes. I should critique you more here, shouldn't I?
You could.
While we're on the air.
At least I have the ability to easily respond in this
I do
case.
It here and there. I guess I criticize you sometimes.
But. So it's good stuff. Entertaining video, and it's free. So go to RidleyReport.com. For more of Dave Ridley's work. He's a pro, by the way. You were trained and you worked at Fox Television.
Yeah, you can't tell that by the quality of my equipment. But I did actually work in the industry for, you know, most of my career. So.
And you've actually been doing Ridley Report as your career, essentially, for how many years now? When did you finally leave Fox in Boston?
Since 2007.
Wow. That's an amazing run. And you know, a lot of people have the vision of doing Liberty Media as their thing. It's not an easy road. It's not a particularly lucrative road. You know,
the cops have helped me.
How's that?
Well, because everybody wants videos of cops. They want to see the cop doing this. They want to see the cop doing that. Even videos of cops doing good things. Mm-hmm. Everybody wants to talk about cops in America. So since there's all these cops around, all I have to do is take pictures of them. It's a guaranteed 10,000 hits, you know, pretty much. If you know, so.
You ought to send them some flowers or something.
It's too much work. And it also seems passive aggressive.
I don't understand. I mean, I guess I just don't get it. How is it that sending flowers to somebody is passive aggressive?
I'm their enemy. You know, I might like them personally. And I might show them respect, but I'm still their enemy, and they're still my enemy while they're wearing
the
uniform.
I don't see it that way.
We just have to accept it as a reality, I think.
I used to think that way about the police, but now I just see them as my confused brothers and sisters who just, you know, they're doing the wrong thing.
Yeah, I didn't say they were evil. I just said they're my enemy. It's like Rommel. Rommel was our enemy, right? Erwin Rommel, the German general. If I'd been alive in the 40s, I would have thought of Erwin Rommel as my enemy, but I still would have liked him. I still would have recognized the many good things about him. But he was still a person who was trying to, help the Germans do all kinds of terrible things to Americans who did not declare war on Germany in the first. It was the Germans' idea. So,
Dave Ridley over at RidleyReport.com. Let's go to Tom. He's in Baltimore listening.
Hold on just a second. Germans may have declared war on Americans, but there's nothing they could do about it. It's not like the Germans were doing anything to America after they declared war.
Well, no, there was some stuff that they did. They killed a lot of civilian mariners, didn't they?
Well, I'm sure that they were going after the mariners. Do you think that the Americans were supplying arms and weapons to the British and other places, the enemies of the Germans? The same as World War
I. Yeah, that's a good point. In World War I, they sunk ships that were not carrying weapons. And I think they did a lot of that in World War
II. How would they know what's carrying a weapon and what's not? It's not like they hang something on the side.
So you just indiscriminately kill them all. That's a problem.
Stay over in your country if you don't want to die. There's a world war going on.
Tom's in Baltimore.
Well, anyway. Okay.
He's listening to LRN.FM. Hello, Tom.
Hi. I think I missed someone disparaging police.
You could pretty much pick all in from all three of us on that one, but I was doing it most recently.
Yeah, but, you know, there's some good ones out there. You know, I, for instance, never arrested anyone for simple drug offenses. And my squad, at least, we railed against and would not enforce some of the crazy directives that came out relative to kids calling the police on their parents because they got slapped. You know, there's a lot of stuff happening in police departments with cops doing what you guys, I think, would very much agree with that you just don't hear about. Of course you're going to hear about the cops that are doing the things that we all, just shudder at the thought of some of those have made the media recently. But I just wanted to point that out.
And thank you for that, Tom. I appreciate it.
Yeah, certainly. And by the way, as far as history is concerned, with Germany, gosh, let me tell you, as far as whoever it was that was talking about the ships that were sunk, actually, I think it was one in particular, Germany actually ran ads saying, listen, don't come over here. Anyone who's thinking about traveling, this is what's been happening, warning people of what was to come. It's surprising to me because I saw that movie, was it Valkyrie? And I thought, you know,
yeah, me too.
Being of German ancestry, I hope I was, or my ancestors at least, were part of that crew. I looked into it, and I'll tell you, I was shocked at what I found. It seems as though we've got a real twisted view of history, and that the bad guys might not have really been the bad guys, as we've been told. Let me give you just one example from my family. Second generation American. My grandmother was from Czechoslovakia. Now, my family, from my grandmother's generation, never complained about Germany or Hitler. Their complaints were about the Soviet Union. And that kind of fits in, well, actually fits in specifically and very correctly with what I've been finding out. As a matter of fact, it's shocking that it's been made a crime to actually question what happened during that war relative to Germany and the Holocaust. Now, that tells you a whole lot when it's made illegal to actually seek out simple information. I think it deserves a real close examination.
Did you know there was a torpedo man on the boat that sunk the Lusitania in World War I, a torpedo man who refused to fire. And he was taken off duty and put in prison for a long time after that.
Tom, stand by. We'll bring you back here. You can continue your discussion with us about whatever happens to be on your mind. That is the point of Free Talk Live. You're free to call in, talk about anything you want. You can also join us on Skype. Our Skype username tonight is lrn.fm. This is Free Talk Live.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow. A new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Just recently, we've witnessed some of the most catastrophic disasters in history. Be sure to prepare yourself with great-tasting, high-quality, GMO-free food that has a 25-year shelf life. Of course, we're talking about the foods from SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. And don't forget, the human body needs up to 3 quarts of water every day to remain healthy and hydrated. So check out our water bricks at SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com or call 877-223-1776.
Hi, this is Walt Augustinowicz. I'm the founder and CEO of ID Stronghold. By now you've heard our commercials about wallets that protect you from electronic pickpocketing. 10 years ago, I created a way to protect my own cards from prying eyes after government officials started talking about issuing a national ID card with a built-in radio chip called RFID. I felt having to broadcast my personal information was an invasion of privacy. Soon after, it was also announced that credit cards, debit cards, U.S. passports, hotel room keys, and even transit passes would all soon incorporate RFID. It was then I formed ID Stronghold to share my inventions in blocking RFID signals with the world. There are a lot of misconceptions out there today about RFID. I encourage everyone to get informed and get protected. Please go to idstronghold.com and get the facts and the wallet, sleeves, or badge holders you need to protect your personal financial data. You'll be pleasantly surprised that through our direct sales model, you won't pay more than other comparable unprotected wallets. It is as though the protection is free. Visit idstronghold.com today.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
My name's Clyde, age 59, now reside in Florence, South Carolina. The doctors diagnosed me as having clogged arteries. Felt like I was carrying heavy concrete blocks around my feet and legs. I started taking Heart and Body Extract as directed. It is less than 3 weeks and I'm like a young man again. It's unbelievable that an herbal formula can work so fast and so powerfully.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free, 855-450. Free. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll free here and join us on the airwaves. 855-450-FREE is the number. And you can also join us online over at freetalklive.com. Get interactive on the website. You can create the content right there on the front page, freetalklive.com. With you in studio, you've got Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
And, of course, we've also got Skype. Skype username tonight is lrn.fm. I also want to invite you to Keenvention. It is coming up. We're about 6 weeks away at this point. It's happening October 30th through November 1st here in our very own beautiful Keene, New Hampshire. It is the event of the fall for the liberty scene in New Hampshire. There's some great. What's so
it's
funny?
It's the fall liberty event.
Is there another one?
No, I don't know.
Okay, it's, so then it is.
All the debutantes will be trotted out at Keenvention.
I don't know if we have debutantes, but we have activists here in New Hampshire, and the Keenvention is a convention about activism. It's run by activists. It is staffed by activists. The panelists, the speakers are all activists, and almost all of them are based here in New Hampshire. We're making a couple of exceptions this year to convention rules.
You're just breaking the rules all over, man.
Well, some would say that rules were made to be broken.
only when it benefits you, pal.
Exactly. And, in this case, it's not going to benefit me. Keenvention is not a profitable venture. It is just something that I think is important to do. So that's why I do it. Keenvention.info is where you can go to learn more about the event. One of the people we're breaking the rules for is Gavin Andreessen, the head programmer of Bitcoin. He is going to be joining us for the Bitcoin panel, which is, I think, going to be the most important Bitcoin panel we have had yet.
Yeah, I think he's rule break worthy.
Absolutely. And
I agree. I'm just kind of amused that Ian had a rule. That rule was you had to be a New Hampshire liberty activist, and a big enough name comes rolling along with the right.
He didn't come rolling along. I asked him.
Yeah, with the right timing, meaning that Bitcoin with the block chain or the block size increase and all that stuff, and maybe we could stretch the rules a little bit for Gavin.
Yeah, it's actually not the first time, Mark.
No, who else was it?
Last time, Garrett wanted to invite a activist from Vermont, and I don't think he was able to make it, so we were I was willing to do it back then too. If there are neighbors, I don't really, you know, that doesn't really bother me. You know, the Gavin, for instance, lives in Amherst, Massachusetts, which is closer to Keene, New Hampshire than is the northern part of New Hampshire, for instance. So, you know, to me, it's all about the activism here, and that's what the real point of Keenevention is, focusing on New Hampshire activism, and that's what we do. The media panel has just been announced for this year. Shire Dude is heading it up. Dave, you actually headed up the first ever media panel back in the 2013 Keenevention, and Mark, you did it last year, and both of your panels were excellent.
Yeah, apparently we didn't do good enough because he'd handed it off to somebody else.
Well, part of the fun of Keenevention is getting different people on stage, Mark, and not doing the same exact
fun
thing
until
every year.
Your little baby's taken away from you and handed off to somebody else like Shire Dude.
Yeah, Shire Dude's going to do a fine job. I'm sure about that. He's a creative personality who is doing some great video work here in New Hampshire. And part of, I think, Keenevention is to show off some of the people who've been doing activism over the last year.
And he looks like Bob and McKenzie from Bob and Doug McKenzie.
I'm not familiar with that. Is it
the
a comedy
troupe? Great White North, the Strange Brew movie.
Oh.
It's who he reminds me of when I look at him.
So Shire Dude, Carlos Morales, our own Daryl W. Perry, and Brett Vinat from the School Sucks Project are going to be on stage and talking about being the media. So whether it's, you know, creating media or doing politics or a cop block, we got all kinds of different panels and some great speakers lined up. You can get your tickets for $60. That gets you in for the entire weekend. You cannot find a convention that is that affordable for an entire weekend. Go and try your best. But $60 or Bitcoin. So up to you. Go to keenevention.info. It's October 30th through November 1st. We'll look forward to seeing you there as we go back to Tom in Baltimore, a former cop who is on the line with us here. I know you had some more comments. Go ahead, Tom.
Yeah, I'll make them quick, and I'll wrap it up and tie it in nice with a bow with actually what I wanted to address about protecting yourself on the Internet. By the way, Ian, you mentioned cop block. You know, I don't know what's going on with cops these days. Back when I was training young officers in the field, myself and the other training officers got together, and this was after just after the Rodney King incident. And we thought, what a fantastic opportunity to spread propaganda among the new graduates that, and it really wasn't a lie, the propaganda can be good. But to put all of them on notice and really put the fear of God in them that there could be a camera around any corner at any time. And I'll tell you, we had these young trainees really on their toes doing a fine job because they were afraid that if they didn't and they made a mistake, even if it wasn't something malicious, that they would be on film, on TV. And you know, the senior officers and the training officers, we loved it. Why cops don't want to be filmed these days, again, it says a lot about what's going on. There's something that's happened where somebody somewhere at some level, when they decided, you know, we don't care whether or not we're actually performing a duty that's honorable and in accordance with the laws as we understand it that actually serves people. You know, I'm quite ashamed at a lot of things that have happened in that arena. Mm-hmm. By the way, relative to, and I'll wrap this up so other people can get on, relative to protecting yourself on the Internet, I've found that the best way to predict future behavior from any opponent or enemy is their past habits. And look at what we're dealing with right now with a really out-of-control criminal government. Look at what they've done in the past. And they're getting sloppy now, too. But what they've done to protect themselves is really a blend of offense and defense. I've never bought into the best defense is a good offense. I think that the best defense is the very best defense you can conjure up. And it doesn't mean you have to spend all your time on it. It doesn't mean you can't be offensive when you need to be. It just means that if you can perfect as best you can a defense that doesn't take an inordinate amount of time, then you're really going to win most of the time. And what the government has done, and this is why I brought that up, what they've done in the past is in plain sight. Take, for instance, what they've done with our currency. They've totally taken an honest currency with bearer notes and turned it into really a fraud. You know, you look at what you have in your wallet these days, you know, I mean, it's right there in plain sight. And they've done this through passing laws. There's your defense. They've been defending themselves in the past. And we take for granted what we think is very similar to what we've seen in the past and what our parents or grandparents, at least, knew as lawful. And again, you compare lawful money with these Federal Reserve notes, and you can see in plain sight, you know, just look at what it says in your wallet.
Sure, you can actually compare directly the old silver certificates, as they were called, to today's Federal Reserve notes, the silver certificates.
They look almost exactly the same, except that it says that you can turn it in for a commensurate amount of silver, which of course you can't now.
I still think it would be fun if someone took a silver certificate into a Federal Reserve bank and video recorded them yourself trying to get your silver for the.
But that sounds like action.
I think it's what's also interesting is you look at the quarters. Quarters used to be made out of silver.
Yeah, they've been totally
debased.
It's the
same looking, this one side of it at least at this point is this basically the same thing, and then they made it out of pot metal.
But it feels different, and
it certainly feels
different. It sounds different as well. Tom, thanks for the call tonight, man. Appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. One thing's for sure about Americans is they are confused when it comes to the government. There's a new survey that's been done over at YouGov.com that has some disturbing results about Americans possibly supporting military coups happening in the United States, and some, you know, very confusing numbers about what people think about government bureaucrats in different categories: military officers, police officers, federal civil servants, local politicians, and congressmen. There's a huge discrepancy between opinions about these different groups among Americans. 855-450-FREE. We'll explore that, and you can join us here on Free Talk Live.
Now is the time to save on hardwood and more at Lumber Liquidators' end of summer clearance sale. We're making room for new fall inventory. That means it's your chance to get an incredible deal on solid pre-finished hardwood for just 99 cents. Wide plank, hand-scraped oak for $1.99. Beautiful carbonized bamboo for $1.29. Plus, get 10 to 15% off Morningstar Bamboo, the number one selling brand of bamboo flooring. Top quality laminate and vinyl plank from 49 cents and 24-month special financing. Hurry, the end of summer clearance sale is going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Before girls' night out, my eczema flared up. Ugh, I felt like canceling. But then I tried Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. It's specially formulated for eczema and has 1% hydrocortisone, the strongest non-prescription itch medicine for fast, lasting itch relief. It quickly stopped the itch and soothed my red, dry, flaky skin. With Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief, I was ready for girls' night out, and it was the best one ever.
Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. Feel the heal. Use as directed.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor, period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Do you owe the IRS money? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. There is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call now for your free and confidential analysis. 800-481-3147. Again, that's 800-481-3147. 800-481-3147.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. We have a few moments remaining, but there's just enough time for you if you want to join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can also join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
ReadlyReport.com.
And Mark.
And also, don't forget, you can join us again at Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. Hey, if you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, you want to help support the show, then please become an amplifier. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. And the idea is you send $5 a month into Free Talk Live, and we will invest that into the show, getting on more radio stations and bringing more internet listeners on board, expanding our satellite footprint around the globe. All of these things are possible. But it takes money, and we can really use your help. Please take a moment, go to amp.freetalklive.com. You can learn more about the AMP program there. And I'm looking forward to making some exciting announcements about AMP, but I don't want to really talk about it at the moment. We're still waiting on some web design to get finished up. And once that's done, we'll have some cool – hopefully by the end of the year at this point. You never know with these web projects how long they're going to take. But hopefully we'll be accepting a new currency for the AMP program. That's all I will say right now. You can extract from that what you want. amp.freetalklive.com. But don't wait for that. Go ahead and give to the AMP program today because it makes a difference right now. AMP, A-M-P, amp.freetalklive.com. You'll get perks too, like access to the AMP-only Facebook group and the AMP-only podcast. Once again, that's amp.freetalklive.com. Story from YouGov.com's Peter Moore. A law professor at West Point was forced to hastily resign after it emerged that he had authored a number of controversial articles. In one, he suggested that legal scholars defending the rights of suspected terrorists could be considered legitimate military targets.
Legal scholars defending the rights of terrorists.
Of suspected terrorists.
Suspected terrorists could be legitimate targets, military targets.
While in another, he examined a potential military coup in the United States, arguing that officers may have a duty to seize control of the federal government if the federal government acted against the interest of the country. Now, what does that actually mean, that statement?
Well, I don't know. It means whatever you want it to mean.
Exactly.
But I think that it's true that, yes, people in the military swear an oath to enemies foreign and swear to protect the country against enemies foreign and domestic. And so therefore, yes, if a politician or group of politicians or even the majority of politicians in Washington, D.C. are acting against the interest of the people of the United States, then yes, I think that they do. Will they? No. And that's not what their job is. Their job is to take orders.
Well, that's the thing with this statement here, the idea that, you know, they have this duty to seize control if the federal government acted against the interest of the country. What is the country? Isn't that the federal government?
Oh, it's me, General. I'm a general, and it's me, because I'm a general.
Well, right.
You know, that's what they all think.
Yeah, and who decides this? The general, in this case, would make that decision. Oh, well, the federal government has acted against our interests, so therefore we need to take over. The military's not interested necessarily in freedom, right? Like, that's not what they're protecting out there. I know that they've been told that. Many of the military members probably believe that at the ground floor, that, you know, we're protecting freedom. But ultimately, they're just following orders. And the just following orders has resulted in all manner of terrible atrocities over, you know, hundreds of years. And the U.S. military is not immune from that. I mean, there's plenty of them just within the last two decades that the military has been involved in. Of course, you know, Guantanamo Bay and the torture over in Iraq. You remember the photos with the torture photos from a while back during the Iraq War, the second Iraq War. I mean, there's so many different things. The story about the 14-year-old girl being raped and killed, raped and murdered by the soldiers. And, you know, there's just a myriad, throwing dogs off of cliffs. So many different atrocities.
You can see how people would, you know, since the military has not, you know, defaced itself quite to the same extent that the politicians have in the United States, except maybe somewhat recently they have, you know, sort of with some of the Iraq and Afghanistan atrocities. But before that, the military had a, you know, not a terribly bad track record as government agencies go. And you can see how people would be more comfortable with them than they are with someone like Obama or Trump or
That's
or,
true,
and it. However, I remember one of my political science professors who was actually in Indonesia for the PKI revolt. It was a communist related, or allegedly communist related, sort of coup type thing. It was just, you know, it was this crazy time where the government won and killed a bunch of people. Who revolted, and he used to say, if you have a coup, it's like a divorce. Once you've had one, you'll never stop having them. It leads you to this cycle of constant coups, mm-hmm. and each government will seem to be worse than the one before it.
Well, that's because the last government that was in place is no longer legitimate because it took it by power rather
right.
than sort of through democratic means.
And they're likely weaker as well. You know, they probably don't have access to the same resources.
But you can see why people would start to think about that, you know, because things are getting that desperate in the U.S. in terms of how bad the government is. And so people start looking at anything as being an improvement. But believe me, it can get a lot worse
sure.
than it is now, not just better.
I mean, it is getting worse in the U.S. There's another survey. The Fraser Institute apparently has released an economic freedom survey, and the U.S. is now down to 16th place or something like that. I had the headline for that today. But the United States military, according to YouGov, has long embraced the idea of civilian control of national affairs. And apart from certain rare moments, the American officer corps has faithfully followed their orders from their civilian superiors.
YouGov's too faithfully.
YouGov's latest research shows, however, that officers in the military are held in much greater esteem than their civilian superiors, and that they are widely viewed as having the best interests of the country in mind instead of their own selfish concerns. 70% of Americans believe that military officers generally want what is best for the country. When it comes,
where do they get this idea? I mean, how many military officers, high-ranking military officers, do we have? I mean, these people are put in place by Congress, an organization that has a 9% approval rating.
Again, remember, it's the history of the United States. If you look back,
but these guys aren't historical. They're modern people.
People are more historical than they think they are.
Agreed.
The really nasty military behavior by the United States is sort of a recent phenomenon in some ways. It's the last 15 years
tell that to the
where
Indians.
Things.
Well, we know more about it. I don't know if
right?
it's a recent
That's why
phenomenon
I say sort of.
As much as we know more about
know.
It because
I mean,
of the information.
If you look at what the military did in the 80s and 90s compared to what it's doing now, yes, there were big question marks you can put on it, but liberating Kosovo, ending the genocide in Bosnia, stopping some of the starvation in Somalia, these are not particularly evil things compared to what the military does now. And people still are, people are always behind in judging things. They judge them based on what was happening 10 years ago in some ways.
Also,
and they're still thinking the military is that old military.
Well, and also with the military, it's more of a general concept. You don't know who these individuals are generally, right? Like, you know, you're talking about hundreds of thousands, over a million people or whatever over all the different branches. I mean, these are a lot of individuals, but we don't know what their beliefs are. And, you know, we don't know what lies they're telling. And we don't know all of the individual atrocities that go on. I mean, even in those things where you're giving good examples of maybe things that they did that were better than what they're doing as a whole, there probably were individual atrocities.
Yeah,
and
these
were
well documented in the 80s. You know, there are a lot of Americans that had huge problems with what the military was doing in the 80s and made an effort to document and protest that. But it just wasn't near as bad as what they're doing now.
But the thing with the difference here is now, again, to contrast this, 71% of Americans believe that the congressmen, however, want what is best for themselves. As opposed to what's best for the country. So all, you know, any illusions about Congress have been well dispersed. I mean, the American people understand these guys are thugs, they're criminals, they're bad folks. You know, they're not helping people, they're only helping themselves. That's pretty clear. There's a lot of news about Congress people being corrupt and, you know, a lot of news about them, you know, doing naughty things or doing things they're not supposed to do. But, you know, the military is just this sort of nebulous concept. It's this more of an idea for people.
Well, you're much less likely to even, I mean, the reporters aren't following generals and colonels around the way that they're following, you know, these guys are doing just as much
I follow the generals around whenever I get a chance.
Yeah, you're not the average reporter. But
there's a certain demeanor and rough and tumble thing about soldiers where they have to face the enemy. They actually have competition, right? Mm-hmm. And you know, they're physically fit, they're gruff, they're kind of interesting, they have an appealing panache to them. That's something a congressman is almost going to have.
Yeah, and they've got that mystique, and they've got the advertising campaigns with the, you know, badass music, and, you know, there's
this
whole
thing. Again, it would be fine if they weren't getting tax dollars, basically, as far as I'm concerned. That's the only beef that's still,
There's also some other numbers here that are interesting. So 70% of people say the military wants what's best for the country. 55% say police officers want what's best for the country. 32% say federal civil servants,
police?
55 on police. Local politicians, 22% want what is best for the country. And congressmen, 12% want is best for the country.
Police.
I got no time. We're out of time, but you can join us tomorrow online in the meantime at freetalklive.com.
Flu season starts with all kinds of symptoms. At Walmart, we can help you be prepared before they show up with products like Mucinex to help relieve chest congestion and Delsym to help silence coughs for 12 hours. You'll also want to be ready with Sudafed PE to relieve sinus congestion and pressure, and Motrin for body aches and to reduce fever. So don't wait until the symptoms have already started. Be prepared for flu season this year. Stock up on everything you need at Walmart.
Use all products as directed.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Many are in disbelief today after word of shocking allegations against a Minnesota-based talk syndication company known as GCN. It's claimed that they're the fourth largest talk syndication company in the U.S., making it even more scandalous that they've been accused of helping business owners expose themselves on a massive scale. Let's go live to Tom for more on this story.
It's being called the greatest exposure of our lifetime, while other business owners are beginning to step forward claiming they too exposed themselves with the help of GCN.
It's true. They're all guilty. Every last one of them. GCN helped me get the exposure my company needed, and just think, that was years ago. Today, GCN has like 700 affiliate stations and over 6 million downloads from iTunes and their website every month.
Imagine the exposure your company can get. Expose your business to the masses. Email advertise at GCNlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective. GCN.
You're listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.